I love y'all, man. That's all I can say. You know, just to stand before the nation of Israel, you know, we talk together on Power Talk like the Hawk said every week, but we're here. You know, we're here together right now. Yah has blessed us and allowed us to come together in one mind, body, and spirit, and fellowship and worship in spirit and in truth.
Hallelujah.
Take this time, this feeling that you have right now in your stomach, I know it's a good feeling, because I feel it right now. And I'm really trying to hold back, you know what I'm saying? Just, man, you know, but... When we're going through our bad times, and I always say this, man, because this really helps. When you're going through your bad times, when you're going through your persecutions, be it on the job or be it, you know, that day when Yah requires you to, the ultimate test of your faith, which is to give your life, you know what I'm saying, like the Messiah did. So when you're going through your persecutions, when you're going through your downs, think about this time. Think about this time right here. This is the good time, y'all. Look at this. Look at how many years of experience we got here standing before us, y'all. Our elders and our emas right here. Look at how many, you know, just a quick testimony, man. Those little Bens who was blowing the shofar today, they just learned how to blow the shofar yesterday. And did y'all hear how good they was blowing? That's only Yah, man. And it's only by the grace of Yah that I'm standing here before you today, man. So, hey, hallelujah, man. Rock steady. Rock steady. Open up in prayer.
All right, fam, if we can stand up for prayer, which way is the east? For you navigators out there, we're going to look towards this way. Elder pointed here, so we're going to go here right now and open up and open in prayer to the Father family, the one and only. There is no other. Could never be.
Yeah.
We can bow our heads, close our eyes, remove from what's before the face as we seek His throne, the Father Yah. Our Abba, who rules the heavens, set apart is your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done in the earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the wicked one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the esteem forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Father Yah, Father Yah, Father Yah, we ask, Father, that your ear opens to the call of your people, Father. What a beautiful day you have given us, Father. In the midst of all the chaos in the world, Father, you showed us, Father, that there is paradise in your bosom. Father, we thank you for all the imams and the elders, Father. Father, we thank you for all the Akim and all the Akotis, Father. Father, we thank you for sound mind, Father. We thank you for the strong will to fight every day to serve your cause, O Yah. Father, we ask you for a blessed Shabbat, O Yah. We ask, Father, that everybody that hear those Ruach-filled words tonight, Father, coming from your servants, O Yah, that everybody be blessed who hear them, O Yah. For Yah, you made promises to us. We made promises to you. We did not fulfill our promises, and you did. Father, we're coming back to you on one accord with one voice, Father. In the name of Yahushua, our Messiah, and together we say, hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Toda Yah!
Toda Yah!
Amen!
Amen!
So be it. Come on, Bruce. Shout for his name's sake. Come on, Bruce. We shout it louder for this in the world. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! All right, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do I need to bring that same box back?
Yeah.
Okay. I'll just bring it out.
We'll let all the short people come on this side.
So fam, here we are. I just want to give a brief testimony. Y'all heard this testimony before. I've talked about it. Moshe's talked about it. And it's the first time I met this Aki, because this is important. Because we're standing up here now as men of Yah, servants of Yah. And when I first met this Ak, he had questions, right? We're sitting down, we're talking. I'm telling him about Yah and stuff, but he was still an Egyptologist. The brother that introduced him to me said, man, he's on here. Okay, I said, okay. So we talk. I said he had a good spirit, but Yah told me, just leave him alone. Just leave him alone. The Ak used to call me after that. I missed his calls, but I never returned him. Yah said, just leave him alone. And then one day I checked my email. Ak said, man, I'm just fed up with this. I'm tired of this. I'm ready to be immersed. I was shouting for joy. I said, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So to see this Ak here, standing next here, as a man of Yah, servant of Yah, I'm going to deliver to you a message of Yah. It is a blessing, but it just shows the power of Yah. So family, whenever we have those, we cannot pass judgment and say, that man ain't going to accept, he's a bum. That woman's not going to accept, she's a harlot. It's not your call. All you got to do is speak those words, and the words is going to change the world. So if the words are going to change the world, how are you going to say that the world can't change this man over here who's a bum or that woman who's a harlot over there? Family, never pass judgment on your people. All, if they have not blasphemed the word of Yah, there's still hope for them. So hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. So we're going to entitle this, How Good It Is for Brothers to Dwell in Unity. And I'm going to let you open it up because look at this. This is brethren. Whatever happens after this, we got this day of unity. Some of us may not be here the next hour. Some of us may not be here tomorrow, but we got unity right now. We must never, ever let that fall from us, family. We have unity. Do you know what that means? The people of Yah, the Gentiles stole his name from us, stole our names from us, and now we're calling on him. Our children are calling on him. How did that happen? You think it's just something that you did? You was a super smart Hebrew? That was his ruach, and we owe him for that. What do he owe? What do he requires of us? Your righteousness. That's it. Your love for one another. That's it. So fam, we are embarking on something so special here. You may not understand it right now, but you're here. You may say, why did I come here with all these brews? You'll find out. Because Yah brought you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. All right, let's Hallelujah. Open up with today's message.
Yeah. Shabbat Shalom, family.
Shabbat Shalom.
I was just checking some notes I had taken before. I wanted to do the just speak about, you know, a continuation of last week's lesson and what's important about us being here and what's important about Jamestown, Virginia. How many of you guys are familiar with the Willie Lynch letter? Okay, by show of hands. All right, hallelujah. You know that this man made that speech on the banks of the James River, you know, and quite possibly it could be where we're going to be standing tomorrow. So, I mean, just the sheer magnitude of what's going to go down tomorrow, man, is that's worthy of giving Yah praise. But in 1660, King Charles II brought forth something called the Council on Slave Relations. And I wanted to make sure I got the date and the names right. When you guys get back, Google that at your own leisure. Now, the Council of Slave Relations, you know, that might not sound like nothing, but that was a very pivotal part in our history because with this council, they forced us to accept Christianity. You see, it was after this implementation that, you know, they started to force Christianity on us. And they gave these hand-picked, you know, Negro preachers, you know, gave them a little bit of authority over us. You know, they instructed them to brainwash us, to believe that, you know, that these people, you know, and this isn't a race thing. You know, this isn't a race thing. I just want to make sure we say that. But
hallelujah.
When you look at the Sistine Chapel, when they show the painting that Michelangelo did of creation, what do you see? You see this bearded Gentile God touching this, you know, Gentile man. That's creation. You see, when they took us out of the book, they took our heritage. They took that away from us, and that's confirmed in Psalms 83, when it says, "Let us remove these people. Let us remove the name of Yah." You see, and then with the institution of the, you know, Jesus, we know that the letter J is the shortest letter in the English alphabet, only been around for about 400 some odd years, 437, I believe, you know. And taking Yahoshua, which means Yah's salvation, it's that simple. Taking that name away from us, taking our ability to call on our Father, giving us pagan titles, that did a number to us. You know, that's why you see brothers and sisters this very day out here, you know, if you go out here in the towns, you'll see brothers and sisters half dressed. You know, brothers berating and belittling sisters. See, when they took the name, they took that authority, they took our power. You see, because Yah is our power. Yael, that's the power of Yah, like the song says, family. So when we come together tomorrow, y'all, we're reclaiming our power because we have that authority, because we are the nation of priests. As it says in Exodus chapter 19, verses 6, that's us that this talking about. That's us. So, you know, now when they try to tell you that these quote-unquote Ashkenaz Jews and stuff like that, yeah, they may be God's chosen people. We're Yah's chosen.
Yeah.
We're going to take back our heritage.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, a hostile takeover of our heritage, y'all. This is ours. You know, we are the way to salvation. Salvation is of the Yehudim or of the Israelites, like it says in John chapter 4, verses 22. Family, how powerful is that? Damn. Our Messiah said he is the door. He is the way through the door. And if anybody else comes through any other way, you are a thief and a robber. So when these people come to you and they address you, you call them as such. You let them know you are a thief and you are a robber. You are a liar. You are of your father, Satan. You are a liar. He is a liar. He is the first murderer. And you do the will of your father. I'm doing the will of my father. See, when you come and you take, you reclaim your heritage. You take back that authority that was stripped from us. Like in the Willie Lynch letter, when they said you take the baddest slave, the biggest slave, let's just say they're going to take Aki Obadiah, right? And they got all of us around this pavilion, right? And they got me standing right here. They tar and feather this brother. They beat him. They kill him in front of all of y'all. What? Women, children, young, old, they don't care. And then they take me and beat me to the verge of death, but they let me live. Just to let you know that we control even how you die. These are the words in the Willie Lynch letter, family. I wish I had the book. I don't have it, but hey, hallelujah. You know what I'm saying? But this is important. This is the significance. We gonna reclaim all of that. Because we can tell them you are a liar. Y'all feel me, man? Y'all don't feel me.
Yeah. Yeah. Keep going.
Let's go.
Come on, Israelites.
You know, y'all willing, we're gonna have our elders come up here and they're gonna share some stories with us. You know, quick testimony, my father, my blood father, he grew up picking cotton. He's 67 years old. They want to make it seem like these things are so distant. Down in Louisiana, right now, people are still living on slave plantations.
Mm-hmm.
Do y'all know that?
Oh, yeah.
People are still sharecropping. You know what I'm saying? If you got a credit card, hey, you might as well call yourself a sharecropper. Because sharecropping was the beginning of the credit, of the whole credit scheme. You see that? Okay, you ain't got no money? I'll let you stay on my land. You can work my land. Your crop don't come in this year? Don't worry about it. I'll give you a little more credit. But I can call it at any time. It's the same thing when you get these credit cards, family. That's why Yah tells us, come out of here, my people. You know what I'm saying? Let's reclaim our heritage. Let's reclaim our history, family. I'm trying to hold back a whole bunch of that, you know what I'm saying?
Bring the fire. Bring the fire. Might as well. Bring the fire.
I'm standing before y'all, man. I love y'all. The significance of these covenants that we're going to take, you know what I'm saying, tomorrow, I'm going to look at my brother. I'm going to look at him eye to eye. And I'm going to call heaven and earth as a witness against us. And I'm going to let him know, hey, till the death of me, you are my brother. Let's take the story of Dawid and Jehonathan. Jehonathan, he and Dawid made a covenant. He said, I love you. I love, man, that's my blood father who's pursuing you, Shaul. But you know what? You got my back. I got your back. You are my spiritual brother. That's the importance of what we're going to do tomorrow. I'm going to look at each and every one of y'all and let y'all know that I may have physical brothers and sisters, mothers and fathers and nieces and nephews, daughters and stuff like that, but you guys do the will of my father, so that makes you my family. That's the significance of what we're going to do tomorrow, y'all. And just one more thing before I pass it back to Aki Obi. When we stand before the Father, y'all, tomorrow, let's clear our hearts and let's clear our minds. You know, we all got, you know, sins that we're trying to let go. No man is more, no higher or lower than anybody. But when we come to the Father, y'all, let's not try to shortchange y'all. This is why we're in the situation we're in right now, y'all. This is why we're going through what we're going through right now, because we tried to shortchange y'all. And y'all has shown you can't shortchange me. You can't say, I'm going to stop smoking after this. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to stop getting high. I mean, we got to stop, y'all. You know what I'm saying? Because in order for the blessings of y'all to be poured out upon us, we got to come to him pure. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to be hard. It's a fight. Damn it, life is a fight. Stand up. Come on, family. Stand up. Hey, if you're talking it, walk it. Now is the time when we walk it, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm willing. I made a covenant with the Father. Yeah, I said I will never touch another drink again. You think I will? How many of y'all think I will?
I don't.
I called heaven and earth as a witness against me. And I said, Abba Yah, as I'm breathing right now, I will never touch that again. Because it's a doorway. It's not a sin. But to me, you know what I'm saying? It says if your right hand causes you to stumble, cut that thing off. And that's what I did. I cut it off. Because I'd rather stumble to the kingdom than walking around with all legs on, you know, and limbs and stuff in the lake of fire. So I'm going to go ahead and pass it back to the Ock, man. I'm trying to deal with these.
Hallelujah.
You know, I said I wasn't going to get all, you know what I'm saying, teary-eyed.
Get it out. Get it.
Man. That's how much,
Hallelujah.
I love all you Imams. You guys are my mothers. You know what I'm saying? I love all you elders. You guys are my fathers. You know what I'm saying? I love all of you Okotis out there. You Okotis are my sisters. You know, all of you Akim out there. You guys are my brothers. And that was shown because if it were not for the will of Yah, we wouldn't be here right now. You know what I'm saying? I mean, just on the physical, real quick. You know what I'm saying? Real talk. we wouldn't have made it here.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But not for the grace of Yah. You know what I'm saying? As shown through my brothers and sisters. You know what I'm saying? Extending their hands. You know what I'm saying? Not caring about, you know, oh, well, he can't make it, so what? You know what I'm saying? But you guys loved me and you cared for me and my family enough to sacrifice and to ensure that we got here. And for that, I'm eternally grateful.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. That's beautiful. All right.
And you know, when Moshe was talking yesterday, and I was just telling him that we know, and y'all know us, we're humble. We don't feed off men and what men say. But when you got a word for us and it's coming from you, the people that Yah has allowed us to feed, do you know how special that is to us? When you come up to us and you say, for the first time ever meeting us, we've been listening to you for this amount of years. What you have said to us with the word of Yah, it has turned our lives around. That is appreciated. And we take that and we say, hallelujah. I don't care what the ones that are not serving Yah, I don't care what they think. They're going to think we're false prophets because they're not serving Yah and they think Yah is false. So we're not concerned with them. But you, what you have to say, how you feel about us, we want to know, and that concerns us. It was so beautiful meeting some of you. I knew your screen names. But meeting you and putting your face, everything together, and it was nothing but pure shalom. Thank you was what we got. That's all we need to hear. Now we know that we're able to pull our swords and we're able to fight another day. Because what we're saying and what Yah has allowed us to do is reaching Yah's people. So that's a blessing. This right here is a blessing. I've been walking this walk and it's nothing. I'm still a babe. But I've been doing this since 1996. And this is the first time really when I'm coming into the midst of people, true unity, Yah. True unity. I've been in the midst of so many scoundrels and so many Israelites. It was just muddy and this is shalom. This is Yah. This is worth 14 years of enduring, and wham, Yah hits you with this. Give him a hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let me tell you. You know, if we make that kingdom, and the day, just think about this, we see Yah face to face. We're no longer in the flesh. We're going to be spirit. So we're able to gaze upon the one that we have always served. Do you know what that moment is going to be like? Every atom and morsel in your body is going to shake, rattle, and roll uncontrollably. It's going to be nothing you can do but shout. Don't you know the Malachim shout before his face day and night?
They shout right now.
Right now.
Hallelujah.
They cannot stop because they know who he is and they know who they serve. You have to be a fool to leave Yah. We know Satan did it, so what that make him? Yeah, Satan is powerful. Yeah, Satan got, you know, certain level of something over humans, but he ain't got nothing over Yah. Satan was a fool for leaving Yah. What made him think? Yeah, he deceived Malachim. Yeah, he deceived man. But yet, he has his reward. This world that you see today, all these people out lollygagging, yah, yah, you know, la, 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 la. This is Yah's day. Do you understand when Joshua met, he said, y'all are not of this world? We're not in this world right now. Look at this. We're on the Shabbat serving our Father in praise and in thanks. Everything around us and doing the things of the world. We're not of this world, family. So we got to continue in this moment. If Yah decide to take the breath of life from your body whenever he does, and you open your eyes in the lake of fire, you can't blame Moshe. You can't blame Obadiah. You can't blame the elders. You can't blame the imams. You can't blame your moms. You blame yourself. Because you made the choice to leave like Satan did. And so, fam, what's the significance that I just talked about Jamestown, Virginia? As the Yah told us on the radio show, James in Hebrew is Yaakov. Genesis chapter 32, verse 28, our father Yaakov's name was changed to Yisrael. No longer shall your name be Jacob or Yaakov, now it's Yisrael. Jamestown is Yisrael town. Where did the father decide to bring us into these ports at? He decided to bring us here in Yisrael town. So we're going back tomorrow. And the Malachim will surround us. Now it's up to Yah whether he want to make their presence seen before us or not. But we know that they're there. They're going to come in protection. And they have been waiting on
this.
That's right.
When we made the covenant in Exodus 19, Exodus 24, blood was required, right?
Yeah.
That was the first covenant. We messed up. We broke it. Yahushua came to renew, right, the covenant. What did he do? He spilled blood. But at the first covenant, not only was blood spilled, but there had to be communication between the people and Yah. Yah said, this is what I require of you. The people had to speak and say, Yah, everything you say, we will do. From the time of Yahushua's death to after his resurrection to this very hour, we have no record of the children of Israel coming together after the blood of the covenant has been spilled to say to Yah, all that you said, we will do. What are we doing tomorrow in YsraylTown? All that you said, we shall do. What did he say? Be obedient to my word, family. You are part of something special, so you can't go out there with a dirty heart. That dirty heart is going to get you in trouble. You are part of something that is momentum. If there ever needed to be anything written about scripture, they will write about tomorrow. So family, we're going to cleanse our hearts. We're going to cleanse our minds. We're going to go out there and we're going to seek his face into the place he brought us into. He said, you are not my people right now. Get out of my face. We're coming back and he said, you are my people. Come before my face. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Man, family, it's going to be a blessing.
Yes, it is. I just want to say something real quick, fam, and then we'll open up the floor because I know you guys have praises and things.
Yes, they do.
Since we're talking about, you know, coming before Father Yah in a prayer of supplication, we've seen it done in Scripture. What was the outcome? Well, we'll take Danayah in the book of Daniel. We read last week in the 9th chapter. Daniel, he came. He gave to Yah that prayer of supplication. What happened after that? Yah opened that brother's understanding, and he got to writing about stuff that he didn't see yet.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But we're going to see that in those days. So family, again, just to speak to the importance of what's going to go down tomorrow, y'all. When we come to the Father Yah in spirit and in truth and beg Father Yah and ask Father Yah to forgive us, he is going to open up our understandings.
Hallelujah.
You know, people will prophesy. You know, understanding will open. People will be able to heal. Because think about this, family. And we were talking about this last night. When they issued the mark, right? And they closed down Kroger, Piggly Wiggly, Food Lion, you know, Jewel, Osco, what have you. Okay. We're going to go get something to eat. Can't go to McDonald's because you need the chip. And if you're worshiping Yah, are you going to take that chip?
No.
There you go.
Let's just say your baby fall and break his leg, right? You need to go to the doctor, right? Can't go to the doctor because thanks to this new Medicaid plan, you got to have that chip, right?
Okay.
Can't go to the doctor because you serve Yah. You going to take that chip? Mm. What? Why would Yah not allow us to heal if we're serving him righteously?
Cain.
Family, prepare yourself for this. It might be Ema. You might have the ability to heal. Yah has already blessed Ema Maima with the ability to interpret. You see, so we see the beginnings of it right now. You know what I'm saying? So family, if you do nothing else tonight, look in the mirror. You know what I'm saying? Like it says in 1 Kings chapter 9, you know, I'm sorry, chapter 8, the 37th or the 39th verse, where Shlomo, he's saying that, you know, when we come to the Father, Yah come with a pure heart because he knows our mind. Yah is going to know what you're dealing with. You know, Aki Obadiah might not know. I might not know. You know, all your brothers and sisters around you might not know. But Yah knows.
Okay.
So make sure you're working on that tonight. Whatever it is. Because none of us are greater or lesser than anybody.
Okay.
Scripture says there's only one master. We are all but brothers and sisters.
That's it.
So let's work together. And when we do that fast tomorrow, that's just Yah helping us because we're all going to be on one accord. We're all going to be fasting together. So when we fast, let's ask that Yah removes those hidden sins, those secret sins that it's not cool to talk about. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
That one thing that's keeping you from crossing the threshold into righteousness. Mm. Let's pray. You know what I'm saying? That Yah removes that when we come together tomorrow at Jamestown, y'all. Let's do that.
Yeah.
So fam, hey man, come on family. Who want to come up, man?
Real quick, y'all. Before we go, because I want you to grab the Bible and just read that 1 Kings chapter 8 so we can just hear how important that is. And I just want to say that the Yah mentioned Daniel. Chapter 9, the beautiful thing about that, when the Malachim stood before Danayah, he said, listen, the moment you gave that prayer, Yah heard it, and Yah sent me to give you the understanding.
Hallelujah.
He didn't delay it, family. Yah hears us when we come to him and we cry out to him. As King Solomon said, this is what they should do. Family, this is a prophecy about us. We're not trying to make ourselves better than the Israelite group. No, it ain't about that. It's about coming and representing the entire nation. Yah said, I was looking for a man to stand in the gap to tell me why I should not destroy this land. He said, I found none, because they was all too wicked for me to even hear. So family, before you can go before his throne, we got to make sure that we are right. Now we got a permanent intercessor. He's going to take the message and say, Father, they're ready. They're ready. And as the ox say, the power will return.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. And just to speak on the power of intercessing, you know, Moses intercessed on our behalf. Mm-hmm. The Malachim, the watchers, they even asked Enoch to intercess on their behalf. Man, can you imagine that? A Malachim? Please, go to Yah and talk to him for us. So family, this is powerful what we're going to do, because we're not only praying for ourselves, we're praying on behalf of those stiffnecks out there who don't know that they're Israel, or those stiffnecks out there who know that they're Israel, but they're still in the world. They got one foot in the world and one foot out the world. We're praying for everybody, family. And that's the importance of this. We're going to read from 1 Malachim. We're going to start at verse 33. This is chapter 8, and this is Aki Shlomo speaking right here. It says, when your people, Israel, are smitten before an enemy because they have sinned against you, and they shall turn back to you and confess your name and pray and make supplication to you in this house, then hear in the heavens and forgive the sin of your people, Israel, and bring them back to the land which you gave their fathers. When the heavens are shut up and there is no rain because they sinned against you, when they pray towards this place and confess your name and turn from their sin because you afflict them. Not the Gentiles, but Yah is afflicting us, family. This ain't a black and white thing. This is a right and wrong thing. And we were wrong. We were wrong. Verse 36. Then hear in the heavens and forgive the sin of your servants, your people, Israel, for you teach them the good way in which they should walk, and should give rain on your land, which you have given your people as an inheritance. When there is scarcity of food in the land, when there is pestilence, blight, mildew, locusts, grasshoppers, when their enemy distresses them in the land of their cities, any plague, any sickness. He's talking about us right now, y'all. Okay. It didn't say in our land, it said in their cities. Okay. Any plague, any sickness. Whatever prayer, whatever supplication made by anyone of all your people, Israel, each knowing the plague of his own heart. Family, each knowing the plague of his own heart. I don't know what you're struggling with, brothers. I don't know what you're struggling with, sisters, but I do know what I'm struggling with, and Yah knows it.
Okay.
So keep that on your mind tomorrow as we go before the Father, family. This is serious.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Whatever prayer, whatever supplication made by any one of all your people, Israel, each knowing the plague of his own heart, and shall spread out his hands towards this house. Then hear in the heavens, your dwelling place, and forgive, and act, and render unto everyone according to all his ways, whose heart you know, because you alone know the hearts of all the sons of men.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I'm telling y'all, man. Hey, it's been said, it's been written, all we gotta do is do it. It's that easy, family. Hey, so with that being said, you got anything else, Aki?
That's it, man. I mean, the people are ready. Let us give some praises and shout and get out to his name, family.
We have the Yahs and the Imams. Come on first. We just want you guys just to speak on it, man. Speak on the magnitude of what's about to transpire. If we could,
Okay, we'll do it like this. We'll get some volunteer elders and some volunteer imams.
There we go. Volunteer elders, volunteer imams.
If y'all put it on your heart to come to this mic and speak, do not crush the spirit. Come on up. Be obedient. Hallelujah.
All right, everyone, hallelujah. I mean, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Bring it up. Let's lift it up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I said hallelujah.
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 All right, I think we got them ready. I just want to say, listen, Yah has been doing some things in my life, especially me and Iman. Not only in our lives, but for your lives. That's why you're here today. Before I met OB and everyone here, Yah has showed us some things. See, he winked at us in our foolishness. We was in a lot of foolishness. And what you see today, it took a lot of faith to do. Everyone coming on planes, everyone driving in, hooking this stuff up, cooking this food, watching your children. Everything, you know, it took faith to do that.
Okay.
Now, when Yah had two people together,
And there's things going on in your lives, and you end up not liking each other, or even just don't want to talk to each other. It don't take much to ask for forgiveness. We struggled with that as a people for many, many years. Many moons. There's many moons that came over this land we're in now, you know? And many sons as well. So what I want to say is, in your hearts, because we have a condition in our minds that need to be dealt with. It really needs to be dealt with. It needs to be uprooted. We've been oppressed so much, and we've been conditioned to think that we hate each other. We don't love each other. You know what I mean? We've been taught that ever since we came to this land. Through the transatlantic slave trade. And when you go up to Williamsburg, you would ask them, and they don't even know what you're talking about. That's what I mean is they act like they don't. You know what I'm saying? Now, Rockefeller, let me just say this real quick. I got a lot of things flood my mind, flood my heart when I talk. You know what I mean? Rockefeller is donating a certain amount of millions up there where we're going to hide the truth. What he been doing for a long time. Him and other diabolical men and women. You know what I'm saying? To keep stuff from us. Now, we can't keep going on with this hate in our hearts. We got to condition the mind first. Uproot this stuff in our minds. So our heart, which everyone has a heart condition, the whole world has a heart condition, that situation in your heart, that's where the problem is. Get rid of that stuff. Get rid of it and ask your brother to forgive you. Ask your sister to forgive you. You know what I mean? Deal with your brother. Cry loud and spare not. That's what Yah wants us to do. Don't sugarcoat whatever is on your heart. Let him know. Save your brother from the fire. Because that's where he or she going. They're going to burn. You know what I mean? Now I'm bringing it to your face, not behind a keyboard. Not on Facebook. You know, because a lot of cats hide on Facebook. And I'm not playing. You know what I'm saying? I'm bringing it to you. I'm not just sitting behind a keyboard saying certain things when I could just bring it to you right now out of love. You know what I mean? Now, it's not the gun that kills a person. It's the consciousness behind it, the trigger. It's not the keyboard that's hurting a person. It's the consciousness behind it, that condition. Get your heart right. Y'all said he, you know, now that I was old, young, now that I'm old, I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed begging bread. You're not begging for bread today. He treating you like royalty. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Kings, queens, princes, prince. You know what I mean? You're royalty today. That's how I look at y'all. That's how I feel. You know? On the inside as well as the outside. May not look pretty on the outside, but you know what? On the inside, I shine like jewelry. You know what I'm saying? When it's raining, the sun is shining. You know? That's how I glow. But I do have a condition. And I'm putting it out there to my brothers and sisters. When I meet people, you know, sometimes I feel like they talk about me. Sometimes I feel like they laugh at me. Sometimes I feel like certain things that ain't right. You know what I'm saying? That's my testimony to you. And how I got this name, Abia, I was talking to an ox right here. My ox right here. I was talking to my ox right here. You know? About how He need to have his name, his Yah-given name. And how I got my name was similar to his. I didn't know who my father was until I was 24. That hurt me bad. And it took Ema to tell me who my father was because that's my mother didn't want to tell me. You know? I went a long time believing a man in my life was my father and really wasn't. He raised me. I loved him. And I didn't want him not be to be my father. But he wasn't. I had to deal with it. I went along those streets walking, wondering who I was. Where do I belong? Where do I fit in? No identity. But you know what? Yah winked at me. He ordered my footsteps. Here I am today amongst my brothers and sisters who have identities. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. Come on. You got an identity. You know who you are. My Ben wrote a song. You know, I know who you are. I know who you are. You know who you are.
Hallelujah.
That's how I accepted Abia. Because it means Yah is my father.
Hallelujah.
Even if I never knew my earthly father, I got a heavenly, a set-apart father. You know what I'm saying? I'm coming at you the way it should be. Cry loud and spare not. You know? Cry loud. Spare not. That's my testimony to you. And I love each and every one of y'all. Really. You got something to say? Do you have something to say?
He got something to say.
Now, let's keep it fun. But this is a serious thing, y'all. I'm keeping it fun.
You making it too real, huh?
Is that, hey, to be real. That's just got to be real. Come real. Come real. Let the Ruach take you.
Come on. The region in this district has did a good job. Hallelujah. And it's Isha, Maria, Ima Maria. And it's hallelujah for Obadiah and Hakimoshe, all of y'all, you know. And I just want to talk, man, because the sun is shining on me and it feels good. Hallelujah. And I see all the young people out here. Yeah, hallelujah. I got to be 51, which is feel right now, you know, hey, it's a blessing. I wasn't supposed to make it this far. You know, I always had health issues, but I've always been a strong overcomer and endurer. You know, you couldn't beat me up. The devil couldn't. He could beat me up, but he couldn't win. You know, I gotta take a beating to give a beating. That's what I was taught. You know, and I was taught that in my faith in my higher power, whom I didn't know by name. But I knew him in here. Hallelujah. I had to fight all my life. I had to fight and not get mad. Cause I can't find his name. I can't find that name. I keep getting these names. And I'm like, no, I just gave up one day. You know, and I just got self-destructed. But you know, y'all can't do that because he put us here. He put Israelite heritage here. He put elders here to tell y'all, young ones, who how to walk with how we had to come in. So you don't have to come in like we did. You know, it's a blessing how y'all are right here. And I was like, wow, if I was 20 and I knew this, if I was 16 and I knew this, whoo, how powerful that would be, you know. But I had to go through terrorist attacks by the enemy. But, you know, hey, I still go through the text, but it's like Job in, I think, chapter 30, verse 33, how Yah will restore you. And I could be wrong with the scripture, but I'm going to say how I know it in my heart, that Yah can restore you like the green, restore your flesh like. Restore your flesh fresh. You know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. You heard me?
Hallelujah.
You know, we can go through right now. We can go through right now, but our reward is that crown of life. Now, when I was growing up, I had to fight a lot. You know, it wasn't easy. I had to fight against racism. And the racism was so thick, I had to be sick. And I had to go to doctors. Wasn't no Hebrew doctors. Wasn't no Hebrew doctors that knew they was Hebrew, you know. But there was all Gentile doctors. And I'm going in there and this man gonna treat me. They got big needles, you know what I'm saying? And I'm like, oh man, what are they gonna put on me now, you know? And it was always something new. When something else, we didn't get to get what's those lawsuits for medical malpractice. I mean, I should be rich, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, like I said, terrorist attacks by the enemy, you know? And, you know, I want to say, you know, life ain't easy when you're growing up in these curses. You know, I have a son, and he left home. And he left home when he was 16, but he got immersed in the name of Yehoshua. And he knows a lot of Yah's words. He sit under Obadiah, sitting right next to me, learning the word, you know, for 2 years. And he chose to go out there, you know, and I go back and forth with myself because I wasn't in his life all the time. I was sick a lot of the time he was young, Then when I finally, God gave me the strength and the healing to come back into his life and fight to get custody when he needed me most, he got to get God's word in 2 years. And that's the best I can do. Hallelujah. But I have to realize that he's born in the curses. You know, he was conceived in the curses. Conceived when I didn't know about God's laws and love like I know now. So, you know, that's how we came about, most of us, you know, in these curses. And y'all have to understand these curses. And as you understand these curses and teach your peers, you do an awful lot of blessing. You know, like Haki being Zephaniah. This used to be Corey, you know, young I, you know, going through. But y'all got his hands on him, you know. But all of y'all young ones, y'all go and teach one this word. You know what I'm saying? If they reject it, move on. They ain't got to go through what a lot of us went through. A lot of us had to fight so many enemies. So many enemies. And then had to come home and fight with a woman that was our enemy. Looked just like us. Looked like our mama. You know what I'm saying? But now we got a woman that will learn, ain't our enemy no more. Because she's coming out of this.
Hallelujah.
Understand her needs, but it's so hard. Now, living with a man like me, it's super hard. Man, I give her all the props in the world. If she left me tomorrow, if she, whatever, I still give her props because it ain't easy being with me. I mean, I'm a loving out, but boy, these folks have put it on y'all's out, elder. But you know what? Hey, I'm a mighty man of y'all. And with that, I'm just going to say hallelujah. I told her, y'all, that I could just give that testimony. And I'm going to give it to y'all.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Put out for the good testimony, Messiah. Brother Messiah. All right. I tell you, it's something, you know, to be here at this particular spot right now, because you know, I had read the Old Testament and about the children of Israel, and during the time, I had no idea for some reason that applied directly to me, you know. And so, see, I'm one of those that, like Aki Moshe was talking about, some of us had to share crop. That was our first credit. I'm one of those that got stuck in that way back in the days. So, yeah, we used to live on the farm, and I never forget. This guy that owned the farm, very rich white man, I mean very rich, owned land as far as the eye can see everywhere you look. It didn't matter which direction you look in, he owned that land. And so he brought us home, and my dad had so many of us, he had 13 of us, a whole tribe. Until man was glad to get us on this land because we were hard workers. My dad was tough. He didn't take no stuff out of us. We had to obey. We were strictly, you know, we had to obey everything he said. It didn't matter what it was. And so that's how we were raised. But, you know, one thing I did notice. Now, before I was 10 years old, I was chopping and picking cotton. Yeah, I picked cotton. I chopped cotton for $3 a day, starting at sunset, 6 o'clock in the morning, a two-hour lunch is from 11 to 1, back out there from 1 o'clock to 6 in the evening. And so, you know, those were days that y'all, he held us. He took care of us. He saw us then going through those hard times, you see. And when I look back on it now, I tell you, it's amazing because I think about the white man. I'm saying the white man, but the Gentile, okay? I think about him because, you know, he was so rich. He had everything. Anything he desired, he had it. But shortly after we left, migrated to the north, we heard, I guess maybe 2 or 3 years later, this same man went hunting one night and he died, froze to death with a bottle of whiskey. He got drunk, him and his pal went out and they were drinking, hunting. And he got drunk and thought he just laid down and kind of relaxed a little bit and froze to death. Yeah, you know,
Scripture says, what does it profit a man to gain the whole world and yet loses his own soul? Now, you know, and so that was one of the things that I look back on. And I think about that, you know. I said, wow, you know, maybe it's not that good that I'm all this rich, that rich in this world, you know. Who knows how I may have acted. Ain't to tell. I may have abused myself, you know. But y'all saw fit that I had to struggle. In every step of the way, I had to learn through hard times how to make it in this world, just to live. And it was all, you know, yeah, because if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have been here. Even going through school, I remember thinking that I was a African American. No, I thought I was a Negro then. Yeah, that's what it was.
That was what it was.
You know, but much to my surprise, I was in class and we had I was taking this course. It was writing. It was a writing course, you know. And I'm writing and talking about, oh yeah, this Negro's here, this that. I turned the paper in, and shortly after I turned the paper in, the teacher. After class, she walks up to me and said, hey, look, you're not a Negro. You are an African-American. I said, oh, wow. How about that? All of a sudden, I done changed. I've become something else because now I'm in school. You know, I came up here. So, you know, what can I say? And so, but anyway, I made it through that. You know, yeah, I'm blessed, you know, for me too. Because see, when we were kids, they taught us, our parents taught us, look, no matter what, you get an education. That's all they know. No matter what, you get an education if you're expected to make it in this world. So, you know, I had that. That was planted in my mind, and that's what I was determined to do. So I set out in my heart to get a college degree. And, he blessed me, you know, to get that at least. And now that's what I do. I work as a profession, as a chiropractor. And, you know, but the thing is, the reason I want to say that, because there was something, some things are starting to happen. Now, I'm just wondering, you know, I'm saying to myself, is Yah really with me? Does he really work with his people? The more I know since I've been in this walk, I see things changing for me, you know, because just last Sunday, for instance, there's this Gentile couple that we know, and we know their friends, and they go to the same church that we used to go to, and this man... He's starting having headaches, and he was in such pain last Saturday until he was in the bed. He could not get up. He called all of his Adventist people to come and pray for him, and they stayed up all night last Saturday night praying for this man, and they even brought one of their friends in that does massage therapy. They brought him in. He massaged the guy, didn't help him at all. By the time I got there, he was talking, I want to commit suicide. In fact, that's why they called me, because that was it. That was the last result. They didn't know nobody else. He had been to every other doctor out there, medical doctor and all. So they had told him they couldn't help him. They've given him CAT scans, MRIs. He's seen it all. They've done all of the studies on him. They don't see anything. They couldn't figure out what was wrong with him. But all he knows, he's in such bad shape. He hurt so bad, he thought his head was going to explode. And so they prayed to God, to Jesus, all night Saturday night. Yeah, and they called me. When they called me, sometimes Sunday, I guess around 10 o'clock Sunday morning, they called me, and they said, well, you know, they don't know my Hebrew name, so they called, Dr. Moore, could you come over here and see what you could do? Because, boy, this Tim, he's ready to commit suicide. He's about ready to die. You know, and when I said, okay, well, I'll tell you what, he said, can you hurry up and come? Okay, I just said, all right, I'll drop everything because, you know, I come. I grab my stuff, I go over to his house, and there he was, laying on the bed. He was just all balled up, hurt so bad. He said if he move any kind of way, he feel that his head going to blow up, and he just started telling me, I'm just ready to go. I'm just ready to just go to the Lord. I'm ready for God to just take me on in. Could you pray with me? I said, wait a minute. I just said, okay, listen, I'll tell you what. I'll pray with you, but let me explain some things to you first. Before I pray to your God, because already I know Jesus and Lord, and y'all been praying to him all night. And he have not helped you all yet. He just did. As a matter of fact, he's getting worse instead of getting better. You know, so he apparently don't hear you today. He haven't heard you all night. So I said, okay. So I explained to him, I said, look, now, let me just tell you this. You know I used to be a Seventh-day Adventist church too, one of you guys, just like y'all. So I know where you're at. So, but let me just explain something to you. You know, I don't pray to Jesus and God anymore. You know, Jesus is not the Messiah's name. First of all, God is not the creator. You know, we know his name now. We know the true name. And if you don't learn and start calling on that name, you may not never get into hell. Because he was sitting there actually ready to commit suicide. It was over. He had given up. But Yah told me to just speak to him in the name of Yah and Yahushua. Explain to him, you know, about the J, Jesus, and all of that. I went through that and let him know who I am. I am a Hebrew Israelite. You know, I explained that to him. This is why how I know it. I went back to Deuteronomy 28, Leviticus 26. I just kind of gave him some highlights out of there so that he'll realize that, look, you know, but you know what? The strangest thing, when I told him I was Hebrew Israelite, oh, okay, yeah, I know. I understand. You know, Gentile. He knows. And so when I got through explaining to him that, I told him, now, if I want to pray, we're going to pray in the name of Yah and Yahushua. Okay, you know, it didn't matter to him because he was hurting so bad then. He didn't care what name I prayed in. He felt that it was going to help him. That's all that mattered to him now. And because I was the last result. I was it. That was it. I was the last doctor that he hadn't tried yet. And so, you know, and so what happened, I went head on and we prayed. And then I started doing what I do. Just the regular stuff I do to everybody else that come into my office with a headache. Nothing special, you know, but I had prayed. And I noticed when I got him, I just made one little adjustment. I recognized what was going on. I knew what his diagnosis was, basically based on what he was telling me. So I just kind of worked from that angle. But I did a little thing, adjusted him, and did a little therapy on him. And it wasn't 10 minutes after I started working on this man. Next thing he said, wow. Pressure is leaving. I don't feel the pressure no more. He said, this is the first time I didn't feel I have been able to feel that pressure go since 2 days ago. He said it's just been going worse than worse. And finally I got to the point where I could stand here and tell you what was wrong, but that's not important. The main thing is how Yah worked. Because I didn't realize that Yah was gonna, well, I tell you what, it's been happening too. And I've been trying to almost ignore it, but, you know, it's getting to the point where I can't ignore what God's doing now, you know, because people are starting to pile into our office that hadn't, you know, and they're going out talking about the both of us, my Isha too, and they've just got nothing but good words to say. And I'm just praising Yah for that. You know, I don't take no credit, none at all. I leave it all up to, you know, I know this is the hand of Yah, because when they come into my office, they see my tassels. If I don't have on my lab jacket, they see it on my clothes. And when I put on my lab jacket, they see it on my lab jacket. And there's no other doctor in town that they're going to go into their office and see tassels hanging off of their lab jacket. So, you know, and I get a lot of questions, people asking me about that. So I'm just trying to show you how Yah is working with his people, you know. And it's just amazing because I tell you, I got to pray and ask Yah to help me help my unbelief. Because I'm trying, you know, something is trying to whisper, oh, yeah, y'all know, you know, that just happened. But you know what? It ain't happening nowhere else in nobody else's office over there. You know? And so something, it has to be Yah. And I appreciate that, you know. And so I just thought I'd share that with you because, you know, before I left that house, it wasn't no more than 20, 30 minutes after working on this man. He was up out of the bed. We were sitting in his front room with his wife, talking and laughing. Everything. Talking to me about how, as he's a construction worker, telling me about how, you know, good, how he could help me build my house if I ever need a house, you know. And so I tell you, I said, you know, this is something I got to share with the family. Yah is working with his people. Oh, just believe. Just believe. And that's what I'm trying to make sure that I don't allow this whispering of Satan try to ease into my head and make me doubt Yah. Because he is doing the work. And I'm just going to stop it from there. Just thank Yah.
Hallelujah.
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 Shabbat shalom, fam.
Shabbat shalom.
My name is Leslie. I have a Hebrew name, but I haven't taken it yet. And after hearing what all the brothers have said before me, I will have it before we leave here.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank Yah through YahsTube for y'all.
Hallelujah.
There was a time in my life where I thought I was a tough guy. But I'm not. And I found out it's all right for men to cry. While I was standing there, I had all these thoughts going through my mind. But as each brother, each elder, you have to forgive me because I'm still trying to get my language together. That I know that y'all will get back to me.
All right.
I know that for a fact. Mm-hmm. But everything that I wanted to say, every one of them touched on it. So all I can do is just say thanks, you know. But I want to thank my Isha.
Hallelujah.
It's Yah's will that she's here. Because I pray that she will come down here with
us. Hallelujah.
If you know the Yah, your Isha well enough, you can look in her face and see what's going on without them opening their mouth. She's been in pain, bodily pain, since she's been down here. But not once has she come to me and said she's ready to go back to the room. Everything's gonna be all right, you know. And even though at times when things don't go all right, it's only because something better's gonna happen down the road anyway. The reason why I can say something better's gonna happen down the road, I remember when I was a child. Well, I wasn't a child. I was old enough to work, and I got my head caught between a truck and a wall, and I felt it getting ready to pop. Right? But Yah caused the driver foot to slide off the clutch. That's when everything was a clutch. For those of y'all that don't know what a clutch is, it's something that has to engage in order for the engine to come. You just don't put it in automatic, now it goes off by itself. But when I got finished running, because it scared me so bad, all I could do was run. And I sat down. When I sat down, the Spirit came to me and told me that I was going to live to be 112 years old.
Wow.
I didn't know then what I know today, because I can look back now and I can see some things manifesting. But I took that sign. And I said, okay, well, I can do what I want to do for 112 years. Since I'm going to live, I'll be 112 years old. So 35 of them years, I went buck wild.
Uh-oh.
I'm telling you that if it was to be done, I did it. I'm like Solomon. When he spoke about the things that he did, he went out there and he tried everything. I tried it.
And for 35 years, I tried it. 20 of them years, I have no recollection of what I tried. I've been playing for the last 15 years.
Hallelujah.
And I'm not bragging on no time or nothing. It's just that we're charged. We all have been chosen, as the scripture said, before the foundation of the world. That at this particular time, we'd be sitting here and doing what we're doing. You know, and we're charged to do what we're supposed to do, which is to go out and spread the word, to teach the nations as to who we are. You know, and
it's all right.
Come on, yeah.
It's great. It's great, you know.
Yeah, good.
Oh man, do you know my mind is racing?
Yeah, it's good.
But I'm trying to slow it down, you know. But it's, then again, it's still not for me to slow down. Y'all have to slow me down in order to get my message across. You know, I've come to understand that the only part that I play in my life is my decision making. And if I don't make the right decision and something go wrong with it, so be it. I got to forgive myself and move on. You know, and then not to make the same mistake again. That's what repentance is all about. But like I said, we're charged to go out and let the nations know. And we're supposed to first do it at home. But the Messiah says that that's where we're going to get our biggest issues from. Because he's going to turn our sisters, well, he ain't going to turn, but Satan's going to turn our sisters, our brothers, our mothers, our fathers against us. You know, so when we're told to go out into all the nations, and I think it's Judah, Samaria, and all the nations. Well, Judah is the first thing we do, which is home. Samaria is the country around us, and then to all, everybody. You know, so when we're charged to go do this, and I don't want to sound like I'm rambling, because Satan is a liar, and I rebuke him. Thank you, brother. Where you at, Moshe? I'm done. Wait a minute. There is one thing. This brother is the mirror image of my life, and I never knew the brother until I got here today. We was talking last night, and everything I've done in my life, he's done the same thing. He's from Philly, I'm from Philly. You're only as sick as your worst secret. You know, but being here, all y'all have accepted me as your family. And I just want to say thank you, you know, and I love you. I truly love you. You don't know how much I love you. Keep the faith.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Now, this always happens. Testing. Can I be heard? Give me a second.
You got a new mic.
I want to ask a question. Do you know who you are? Are you Egyptian?
No.
Are you African American?
No.
Don't give me cuss.
Who are you?
Israelite.
Who are you?
Israelite.
The chosen people.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to go about this another way. Elder told my story. I wasn't going to tell. That's okay. I'm going about this another way because I have so much to thank y'all for. So much. I want to talk to the young people. I want to talk to the children. Can't hear me? See? Told you.
I can hear you.
Told you.
Go ahead.
I want to talk to the children and the young people
about where I came from. I want to talk about the days of the 60s. Black power.
Right on, right on.
Power to the people.
Right on.
I was coming up at that time. I was coming up that time where our community was starting to change. We started having some pride about ourselves. Some, you want to say, racial pride. That's when I came up with the time where we were starting to wake up and beginning to see that we were more than just what we were labeled: lazy, ignorant, ugly, black, uneducated. And Yah had sent some people to us, had been sending men and women to us ever since post-slavery, even during slavery. These men and women, they worked hard at their craft to educate us, to awaken us, to let us know there's a new day. Think about Moshe in Egyptology. I was on there. I wasn't there. I was there. I was on board. Somewhat on board. Because I was young, and just like any young person, I didn't want to hear everything my parents had to say to me, or any relative, or back then, any neighbor. Because neighbors loved you too. Neighbors could tell you, boy, what you doing? You better stop. You better take your behind in the house. You know it's too late to be out here. Or you out there with that girl on the corner. Go home, girl. I'm going to tell your parents. Nobody turned back and rolled their eyes or cussed them out. No disrespect there. If you had anything you want to say, you better keep it to yourself. I remember I hope school. I was in the eighth grade. Got caught. One of the neighbors saw me. What are you doing around here? How come you're not in school? Catch me, I'm caught. It's hard for me to say a lie. Not that I'm perfect, I'm not George Washington. It's just hard. When you catch me, you catch me. Police used to catch it up with me. I wouldn't admit, but I give up. You got me. I don't want to sound like I'm rambling either. But what I want to say is to the young people, as I was saying, people did some serious things with their lives. But only thing about these Hebrews who didn't know they were Hebrews. And that was the problem. They didn't know who they were. They didn't know who they truly were. They thought they were African-American. They thought they were Afro-American. They thought they were colored. They thought they were Negro. And they thought they were going to free us and we were going to recognize our Africanness. You see? Power to the people. I love those brothers and those sisters back then. They did what they thought they were doing was right. And I give them my utmost respect. So I traveled around doing some crazy things, being young, didn't want to listen. But then there came a time in 19... Oh, here we go.
Go ahead, tell it. Don't make me.
Here we go. 1976. The Great Olympics. We had the greatest amateur boxers in the history of amateur Olympic boxing. And we had roots. Follow that. We had roots. Roots also helped change our thinking. It also put fear in a lot of Gentiles. And a lot of us walked around with attitudes. Like somebody owed us something. I'm glad I'm sure you read that scripture. Who did it to us? Yah did it to us. Why did he do it to us? We were disobedient. We didn't love Yah. We didn't even love ourselves. But for the grace of Yah today, we have to teach our children that who they are Hebrew. They are of the Israelite nation. Today we can't let no one come in between that. We can't allow no one to tell us anymore. It's over. It's not going to happen anymore. That we're something other than the children of the Most High Yah.
Hallelujah.
This is what we got. Hallelujah. This is what we got to stand on. This is what we have to die for. I remember as a child, I used to go to Baltimore sometime. I'm born in Philadelphia, but I used to visit one of my aunts. I was about 9 years old, and she took me downtown, Baltimore. We went to one of the department stores called X. And I remember she was looking at some dresses. So I'm talking about 1959, and she was looking at some dresses. And the lady in the store kept following her around, just kept following her around, following her around, following her around. And every time she would touch the dress, well, she touched it once too many. And she said, "Are you going to buy that?" My aunt said, "I don't know." "Well, you keep touching that, you're going to buy it. And you know what? You can't wear that in here. So why don't you get that dress and get on out of here, girl or gal?" I remember my aunt was an older woman. She was older than this lady. tripped me out. I'm looking up. Wow, what's this? I wasn't experiencing that in Philadelphia. Probably was there, but I didn't experience it. Came back 3 years later or so when I was 12 years old. Moving to Baltimore. And my uncle was lost, so he stopped on the side of the street, and it was kind of late. And he asked a white man, "Excuse me, sir, can you tell me where Archer Street is?" And he stopped, and he leaned over down into the car. He said, "Boy," another man that was older than him, "Boy, you talking to me?" "Yes, sir. I was just wondering, can you tell me where Archer Street is?" He said, "Nigga, don't you ask me no questions. You don't stop me to ask me nothing." Wow. Another shocker. Reality check. See? I'm saying this to say to the young people, you don't know. You don't know what people went through before you. You don't know what Hebrews went through before you. Don't take it lightly. It breaks my heart to see this entertainment world. Hollywood, it breaks my heart. Sports, it breaks my heart. I love sports. I played sports. I had a big ego because I was short. And there wasn't nobody going to beat me in basketball. Nobody going to beat me in baseball. You know, we were short. We were small. You know, we had to get that big head. And we played big. Nobody. Where's that arc at? Back there. You know, I didn't care how tall you was, how big you was. You going. Even when I boxed. Because when I laid the brick on you, you going down. I didn't call the hammer. I didn't call the hammer. It felt like a brick. Because when I hit you, wham, life would go off in my head. And it felt just like I just slapped you with a brick. And hello, you said what? I love you. You made me do that. And that's the honest truth. That's the honest truth. I would sometimes cry because I wouldn't pick on you. But I just played hard. And if you tried to hurt me, I will hurt you back. See? Because we came from Philly. Philly is known for fighters.
Uh-oh.
You know, I can stand up and give you a pose now. You know, 60 years old, I can give you a pose. See, I don't know how good my left hook is today, but I can give it. Give me some Ali, all that stuff. I got me music. I got Donna Summers. Got Donna Summers. I work out the Donna Summers skip, bro. You know. But I just say to the young people, I say to all of my people, I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Whether you recognize that you're Hebrew or not, I love you. I might not like what the world and the people in the world is about, but guess what? I understand. They don't know. They don't know what I know. And I never thought I was better than anyone, except sports. But I never thought I was better than anyone. But I've learned through the grace and the goodness of Yah with his teachings to me that I am to know better. To know better. And to do better. But not try to be better in the way that the world talks about than the other person. You see? So, I just want to say to the young people, don't let this entertainment world, don't let Hollywood, don't let these videos, don't let nothing outside the world that tells you about this fast money, this beautiful life, and everybody's going to love you once you get there. Let me tell you something. Those people have problems. Those people have problems day and night, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And a lot of them, I have to believe, they've sold their souls to Satan. But I have to believe a lot of them cry every night, what was I thinking about? So I pray for them. I pray for them. They don't know. They don't know. And some do know, but they gave it up. So I say this. Don't let no one, don't let the adversary come to you. Don't let the adversary come to you as a sweet-smelling, beautiful, cool, handsome in the sky, person in disguise. No. And learn your scriptures. Listen and sit with your parents. Sit with your uncles. Sit with your grandparents. Listen. Ask questions. Because guess what? We're the last generation to remember. We're the last. Up here, we're the last. After us, it's you. You don't know. We are the last to experience what we experience.
Hallelujah.
Yah has brought us a long way. I love everyone here. I pray that Yah keep his hands on this organization. I pray that Yah keep his hands on each and every one of you. Because as the ox says, this isn't by accident that we are here. This isn't by a happen chance that we are here. Before the foundation of the earth, it was already settled. And that makes me feel good. I say hallelujah. Hallelujah. I finally found myself. I finally found a place. Because I looked so many places. So many places I looked. It was hurt. It had to hurt. All I wanted to do was live the life that I thought, and I knew something wasn't right in this world. I knew that. And my anger caused me. My depression caused me to fall, to roll, to try to commit suicide, to hurt sisters, to continue to run into one relationship to another. with no avail. I'm home now. I can't wait to his kingdom come. I want to be there when his kingdom come. I want him to come up. And I want to see each and every one of you that are here. And I'm praying that we grow as a people. We love as a people. Put aside. And the first thing we must do to put aside those hidden things within us that nobody else knows about, and we have to do it ourselves. We have to pray. We have to be honest with ourselves. And that's where it begins. Look at myself. If I point at you, these fingers will point right back at me. They're pointing right back at me. See? It all starts with self. And everything we learn, it should come. Everything our children learn, it should come from our homes. Don't depend. If our children in these public schools, these schools out here, don't depend on those schools. And I think we all know that because we have good teachers. They done already taught us that. But it should always come from the home first. And it was commanded to us. It was commanded to the Akotis. It was commanded to the Akim to keep his word and always remember it and give it to the children so they can teach their children, and their children can teach their children and their children and on and generation after generation. Man, this is beautiful stuff. Yes, yes. I thought I was out in the world with some beautiful. This is beautiful stuff here.
Right.
I just want to say hallelujah. I'm going to pass this mic over.
Hallelujah.
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 Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
It is good to be here. I just stand here to tell you that I love you. Never give up. Don't turn back. Satan is back there. Don't turn back. Keep on going forward. Yah is with you. Did you know that Yah knew you were going to be here today? Did you know that? Yah talked to Abraham a few thousand years ago. That's right. A few thousand years ago, Yah was waiting on you. He was waiting on Yah. That's right. You stand here. You don't know who you are. Yah know who you are. Children of the Most High, Yah. You are royalty. Stand up. Don't turn back. I love you. May Yah bless you and keep you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Told out for the elders. I thought I was going to have to bring out the red dot here. But hey, we got it under control. Hallelujah. So, fam, what we're going to do now is that we've heard from the elders. We're going to ask if you all want to have anything to say, or if any of the imams want to come up and, you know, just give a word. If you got, you know, a song, dance. I'm going to request a Coach EC to come up and give us one of her world famous poems. By request. Come on up, Coach E. You know you've been waiting on this, trying to act all shy. She's been waiting on this, boy. The floor is yours, Coach. Get on up here. Hallelujah.
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 All right. All right. So I know we got some singers out there. I know, you know, we got some praise that's going to take place. Family, this is the schedule we're going to do. We're going to go ahead and praise and worship until 6 o'clock. Then we're going to have some grub. Then we're going to do the concert to 7. We're going to get looking at the premiere at about 9 o'clock. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All right. Here you go, Cole. And you got to be animated when you do it. You know how you do it when we ain't looking at you. You know how. Just like she did in the curses, right? She got to do it like that, right? Hallelujah.
I'm just saying, why I got to be first?
Because you're first. You're not last no more.
I'm so nervous. It's different when you just don't pass. I can just look at you. Okay. Since I knew I was going to be put on the spot, I was thinking about what piece I was going to do, and I got some requests about one poem that I started out doing in the curses, but a lot of people don't know that that was just not even half of the poem. That was just, it was cut. So my husband begged me, and I got some requests for some elders, so I'm going to go ahead and do the Freedom of the Illusion, one in its entirety. See, a lot of y'all don't know that I'm actually shy, but yeah. I am. It's amazing what y'all gives to you, cause like I'm really shy. Like, ask the coaches at the G1. Like, I'm quiet. A lot of coaches is like, you so quiet. That's really how I am. I'm quiet. There's a strange fruit hanging from the trees, but not the kind of Billie Holiday's days with blood out on the leaves. But these are a different set of trees, and they bear a strange fruit called ignorance with an illusion up its sleeve. An illusion so thick, sometimes it's hard to breathe. But who will hearken to Yah's fresh air? Who would all believe? I feel like I am in the days of Dr. Martin Luther King, back when black folks marched and sang songs and Martin had a dream, but what exactly was his dream? I asked myself over and over these things, what exactly was his dream? I thought it, so my thoughts led me to February 1818. Here was born Frederick Douglass, a man who also had this dream. To not have to work the cotton fields, courtesy of the curses, was his dream. See, to not be so black, so dark, this was his dream. And in 1845, he found himself on a winning team. Tired of hearing screams of being slapped up, he slipped up into a secret society. Wanting to be a part of this world so bad, he joined the American Anti-Slavery Society. Mistakenly joining a secret society, determined to tear us away from our own society. This was his conclusion. Mr. Douglass, my friends, got caught up in the illusion. So being women, some of us, and enjoying the company of women, the other half of us, our thoughts led us to some women's tales. We thought, well, most certainly we can get our answer for Mrs. Ida B. Wells. So as I studied her story and searched for this dream, my mind began to drift away as I saw that she too had this dream. She too had this purpose. She too wanted to escape the curses. Blinded by a fake reality, she too joined the secret society, also known as the NAACP, created by Jews, led by intelligent fools with black skins who sought to escape the bodies they were in. So, like Douglass, Ida became confused in a world of turmoil that led her to believe her own confusion. She too got caught up in the illusion. But some way, somehow, we had to figure out our own existence, our own being, so we continued our search for Martin's dream. Our thought's destination had to steer toward education, so take it, it's yours. This led us to, of course, W.E.B. Du Bois. Something about this man caused an excitement that rushed through you and me. We became admired at his intellectual ability, and we thought, sure, now this man could school me. However, my mind became stumped as I ran across this myth and found that my admirer was in favor of the talented 10th. To my astonishment, he too had this dream. He too wanted to be on what he thought was the winning team. See, because the boys didn't understand the curses, he created the Crisis magazine that taught young people like me and you that you cannot be set apart, that you cannot follow Yah's heart. So as we called up to Dr. Martin Luther King and we heard his many speeches singing, I had a dream, we too began to lust for this very dream, even if it was not real. All we had to do was feel like we had that dream. Even if our arthritis lingers and our cancer could still be felt in the fingers and our AIDS rate keep growing and our blood stop flowing, even in the midst of the curses and confusion, instead of seek Yah, we'd rather give ear to this freedom. The illusion, and that's the piece.
Hallelujah! 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 Excellent. Woo. We got the stage set, fam. Let's keep this fire going. This righteous fire. You know, the kind that burns the bush, yet the bush is not consumed. Hallelujah. Come on up, Bruce. What are you doing? Raise your hand. Get in line. You know how we do it. Where y'all at? Oh, Big Eye, that's you said that? Come on, I can sing that song you told me about.
Oh.
Man, even though, hey, Big Eye can do it, y'all. Oh. But when he do it, then that's when I do it. So if he never do it.
Oh, he never
do it. Oh. Come on up. Come on. Come on. Y'all ain't shy.
Look at that.
There he go.
Look at that.
Oh, you gonna do it?
Oh,
hey.
Goodness.
Oh, you gotta do it now.
Okay. This song is called I'm Not Really Gonna Sing.
Oh.
Hey, shalom, pal. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom, everybody. Man, I'm glad to be here. I'm glad I made it. Because I was having doubts about coming, but hey, y'all had other plans for me. And with me, it's like you gotta learn to listen to y'all. You have to learn to listen to y'all. You have to learn to be obedient to his word despite what your heart and your mind is telling you. If I offend any one of you, anybody here, you have to allow me the chance to correct that. You have to allow me the chance to say, hey, Akoti, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I might offend you without even knowing that I'm offending you. You know, so you have to allow me that chance. You can't hold it in, because when you hold it in, it'll turn on you. It'll make you hate me, and I won't understand why you hate me, and I won't be able to ask you why you hate me, you know? Because last year, all of the faces that was there are not here, and I was naive. I was naive to think when I came into this truth that everybody that Yah had put and gave to me as my brothers and sisters was going to not be my brother and my sister. My brothers and sisters are those that do the will of my father. And when you stop doing the will of my father, you're no longer my brother or my sister. And it's saddening to me every time I see somebody leave, because Yah put us here.
Hallelujah.
Yah put us here. I didn't just pop up. This is no coincidence that I'm standing before you.
Sure.
You know, Yah put me here. So I got to do everything within my power to stay where Yah put me. I can't go on my own understanding. I can't go and say, think I'm going to do something different than what Yah has planned for me. So I have to fight to stay here. If anything comes upon me that tells me that I need to do something else, I need to check that spirit immediately. Immediately. You know, why am I thinking like this? You know, when I thought that Yah put me, when I know Yah put me someplace and I'm thinking something different than what Yah told me, then I need to check that immediately, you know. And living down in G1, all of us together, you know, we learned a lesson. Yah is grooming us, you know. For whatever reason he chose to put that little certain group of people where he put us, he's grooming us. For whatever he's grooming us for, he's teaching us a lot of lessons about how we're actually supposed to apply this word and live it. Because we all know the word, just like all those people that left. They all knew the word. But they couldn't bring their hearts to apply that word. They were so busy pointing fingers that they couldn't see that it was themselves that was wrong. And they needed to apply the scriptures and do the right thing. Because y'all not going to say, hey, I'm wrong. Who did something to you? So I can repay them. I'll say, why didn't you do what the word said?
Right.
So I got to obey the word. Right. Ain't gonna be no excuses. There is no middle ground. We have to obey Yah. We have to stay where Yah puts us. You know, and this, after this documentary,
probably going to be the same thing like it was last year. We left that place in love. People was on fire. Oh, it was beautiful. Oh, you know, man, the brothers and sisters, oh, we had a beautiful time. And shortly afterwards, it started crumbling. People just, for whatever reason, felt that they couldn't fix the problem that was at hand. We have to fix the problem. See, when we was in the world, we say, hey, bump them. I'm got to deal with them. You know, I'm going to be over here. But you can't do that in this walk. See, that's of the world. That's of the flesh. You got to fix the problem. Whatever the problem is, you got to fix it. You got to fix it. Or you're going to have a problem. You know, you'll be the one trying to keep a feast day. Now you're sinning. Doing something other than what the words say. You adding to or taking away from. So now you out of line. And once that sin steps in, then another sin can come in. Then another sin can come in. And you back in the world.
Mommy,
gotta fix it.
Go, mommy.
That's what this is about. This is not just about, you know, us have coming together and having a good time. This is about learning to apply that word. Know that word. Apply that word. You know? That's what it's about. That's what it's about. And it's about growth. Because just like EC said, she's shy, I'm shy too. But I'm comfortable right now. You know, I'm comfortable in front of y'all. Y'all family. I'm comfortable right here. You know, but I guess my mom damaged me. You know, she was always put a little funny suit on me, take me to church. Get out there and say this poem or something, you know. So anytime I come in front of a crowd, I sweat. I've never been doing this. And I say, you know, I want to say Toda to Aki Obadiah, because he's definitely the reason that I do the things that I do. Because if not, I'd be in the background, you know, hoping nobody noticed me so I don't have to do no work, you know. But he wasn't going to let me do that, because before he started the power talk, it was just us. It was just me and Moshe and my sister, Zakia, who left, Obadiah, and EC, you know, it was just us. And he put a mic in my hand and put a camera in my face, and, you know, hey, I need you to do this. And it's like, man, I'm doing the work, but yeah, I can't say no, you know. So I had to grow. I had to, you know, I had to change. And, you know, we all got to change. Change is good. That's what we're supposed to be doing. It's changing. We're supposed to be changing from who we were to who y'all wants us to be.
Hallelujah.
And we got a big job ahead of us, you know. We got to continue. We're dealing with a stiff-necked people, you know. So we really got a lot of work to do. So, you know, the different projects we have going on with the org, step up.
Yeah.
Step up, you know. Do a little something, because it's like the same people doing the same thing, you know, and it's like, oh, you know, dump something else in my lap. Hey, I need you to do this. It's like, man, it's like 500 members. You know, can somebody else do something? You know, I don't want to say no, but, you know, if I got to do it, I'll do it. But, you know, ask somebody else and then ask me. You know? But, man, family, I know it's hard, you know, but I'm going to start a new committee where I'm going to just start picking people and people don't start standing up. I'm serious. You know, people start helping out. Then, you know, just like in high school, you know, people sit in the back and they don't want to get picked. You know what I'm saying? So the teacher got to call on them. Hey, come on up to the front. You know, sometimes we need that little push, you know, that little kick in the pants, you know, get on up there and do it. And I say hallelujah for pushing me on out there, because if not, I definitely wouldn't have done it. And, man, this is beautiful, fam, you know. Hey, stick to the word, you know, and, hey, apply it. Apply that word. Any offense in your heart, get rid of it. You know how you get rid of it? You go to that person. That's why the scripture tell you that. You go to that person. And it's humbling. It's very humbling. It's embarrassing to a certain extent, you know. to be honest with it, you know, because I didn't have to come to Obi and he didn't know what I was talking about, but I had to tell him every wicked thing that was on my heart concerning him. And you know what happened after I told him all that? He forgave me, you know, because it wasn't really me. It was a spirit trying to get me to go against my brother. And after I came to my brother and I told him everything that was on my heart, you know, feeling really like bad that I gotta tell you this, you know? And after I told him, the weight was lifted. That demon ain't had no more power. Mm-hmm. Because I released everything that he was using in my heart against me to try to tear me and my brother apart.
Yeah.
You know, and I say hallelujah that he understood. Hallelujah. He knew why I was doing what I was doing. Why I was telling him the things that I was telling him. This is a spiritual thing, and it's not a joke, because we listen to these lessons and think, yeah, hallelujah, good lesson. But these spirits are real. They are real. And they, when they speak to you, it's like your own thoughts. It's like it's you, but it's not you. And the only way I knew it wasn't me, because what I was thinking didn't match what I was feeling. This is my brother. I know this is my brother. So why am I thinking evil of him? You know? These spirits are real. And you have to learn to discern a spirit. And you have to learn to get that off your heart quickly. The quicker, the better. That's what we're learning about in G1. We have a problem. We immediately, hey, we need to talk. Everybody, now stop what you're doing. We need to sit down. And we all sit around, and everybody, hey, everything everybody got a problem with, they put it on the table. And when we get up, hallelujah. Now, hey, let's eat. You know, what you was doing, you know, get the bird grilling again, it's on, you know. And that's how you do it. That's how you do it, you know. I mean, why is it that all these other people can live together, but we can't? And then we try to live together, and it's like we have all these problems. I'm talking about people in the world. You know, we have all these problems because you don't fix them. Because you say, bump them. I don't need them. You know, I'll find me someplace else to go. You know, you quick to drop or dismiss that person or people or whatever. Mm-hmm. Got to fix it. Got to deal with it. The sooner the better. Mm-hmm. And be honest. Feel your heart. You know? And I ain't gonna hog the mic. I ain't gonna ramble. I say hallelujah. Todah yah. Hey, thank y'all for listening to me. Hallelujah. Shabbat shalom.
Good words, y'all. But I'm a little offended now. Because you haven't sung yet. No. You said you're comfortable with us. Let us see. Come on, man. One day, okay. Check this out. I guess one day when I force him to sing, he ain't gonna stop singing. About to take the mic out of his hand, you know? But fam, I want y'all to hear this brother's testimony real quick. Then we got the little Coty here. She's gonna come up with a poem. But this brother told me something today that was I heard this before about 5 years ago from another op. But what he got to tell you is profound. And I want to come up and just give a small commentary on what he said. But just listen up. Because this thing is real, fam, what we're involved in. Here you go, Ot.
Shabbat shalom, fam.
Shabbat shalom.
I almost asked for a 7. I don't know why. But yesterday, I think it was, before me and my... Okay. Before me and my wife made our trip up here, I made a stop at a little store to get some pants. And some Israeli guy ran the store. And when I asked him for some pants, he took a look at my pants and he saw my tassels. And he was like, oh, you a Hebrew? And I'm like, yeah. He like, how long did you know? And I'm like, I know, right? I'm like, for about 6 months now. And, you know, he proceeded to, you know, have a conversation with me about it. And the guy even gave me a discount, you know what I mean? So, hallelujah for that. But, you know, that was just about it.
That story, fam, they know who you are. They know that you are lost here. That's why he say, when did you find out? How long have you known this? I knew it already, says the Israeli, but how long have you known it? That's that deep thing, fam. This thing is real. They know. That's why you have these Jews always spying on us. The NAACP is founded by a Jew. They're constantly watching us. You know why? They know that, hey, these gatherings like this, us coming together, their time is short. Uh-oh, the people are coming back. We took their identity. We got to give it up now. Hallelujah. 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 All right, we're going to bring the little Coachy up here, and she's going to give y'all a poem, make her feel welcome. She told me, oh, Dad, I got a few butterflies in my stomach. But I'm telling you, fam, when I first met her, she was going a mile a minute. She told me, oh, Dad, those lessons are powerful. I said, what? You listen to the lessons? You know, so hallelujah. So she's going to bring it to you, fam. Go ahead. You got no worries, no concern. This is your family, and they welcome you. Go ahead.
Hallelujah. Shabbat shalom, everybody. My name is Deavion Brown, and I have a poem called He Was Our Us. He was our us. You say, I need the drugs, I must. You worship gods and scream over worldly things like iPods. And you say, Jesus, oh, Jesus will free us. Oh, Israel, should you must. And still, you go around and cuss and fuss. And then, when somebody tries to tell, you eat the raw meat with vomit. And somebody tries to tell you the truth, you can't comment. And remember, Hebrews are us. You are not black. Don't slack. You're better than that. And remember, Hebrews are us.
That was off the chain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is just entirely beautiful. So, fam, we got anybody else want to come up with anything? Imaj. Segulia is here. Hallelujah. She's going to bless us with some song. I know she is. And words of encouragement. Those of you all that are on Yah's Voice, look forward to her emails every day. I know I do. I'd be like, okay, where are they? Where are they at? You know? So, hey, I just want to give you all, as Big God talked about last year, we had people to leave. I'm going to give you a little incentive to stay. We have this gathering next year. Y'all blesses us to do so. Myself, Moshe, and Big God going to come up here and do some old school temptation with a y'all feel. So if you want to see that, you got to stay around. It's worthy to stay around. Here you go, Eva.
Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. And as Shem would say, Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. I just wanted to say that this has been a journey getting here. It's been 2 years and a little bit that I've been with the org, and I have to thank one very special person other than Yah. I have to thank my deep and dear sister, Ima Zahara. Oh, she called me at work one day and said, Cassie, I have something I want you to see. Do you think you can look at it? And don't judge it, just look at it. She's been my spiritual partner for 20 years. So I said, sure. So I flipped to the site, and the first thing I saw was the physical appearances. And I read through it, and I screamed. I shouted in my office, and my boss came in. He said, what are you doing? It doesn't sound like work. I said, it's not. This is joy. I'm 56 years old, and I finally know who I am. I said, this is tremendous. I said, you can leave now, because I have some more to read. So we left. And you know, if you work for the Department of the Army, that doesn't usually happen. You can't take the Army's time doing Christian stuff as he thought it was. And so I read it, and I think I burned up about four or five reams of paper, printing off the lessons. And my heart was filled to overflowing because since I was 9 years old, questions that no one would answer. They didn't have an answer for a 9-year-old black child in 1962, 64, saying, why does this happen to my people? Why is it we can't get any higher than the lint under the padding, under the rug, without being knocked back to dust totally? Why is it that we go to church on Sunday when it says right here in this book, in this Bible that you make me read, that the seventh day of the week is Saturday? Why? And then I let it go because nobody answers. You know how we did back then. Our parents said, that's it, that's all. And that was it, and that was all. And my husband, I met my husband, and he grew up Catholic. And he had been expelled from school on numerous occasions because he told the priest, you're a lion. The Sabbath is Saturday. How can you keep making us do this? And he was, that was his question. Then he met my mom. Well, he met me. And I told him about Shabbat, as I knew it, as the Sabbath. And he said, oh, he said, well, that's cool. That's cool. And then he went in to talk to my mother, and he sat at her feet, and he listened to her. He listened to her, and he had it better than I did. I had a form, and it was a fashion of. I knew God, because that was what I was told to call him. But I knew him. I knew him very deeply. But then I found Psalm 68:4, one Shabbat. Obi said it. And I looked it up, and it was like my heart jumped out of my chest. I'm like, well, I know I've read this before. I've been thumping this Bible 30 years. I know I've seen that scripture before. Why? Why didn't it mean anything to me? Because the other scripture says, just for such a time as this. And I was at the end of my search, and I told Wobo, where do I go? I don't want to. I cannot go to another Sabbath service in church. I just can't go there anymore. I would get up. The last one I went to, I got up. I ran out. I ran out of my church. And I stood outside and I said, Father, where do I go? What do I do? Am I such a reprobate person that I have to stand outside and not know where to go? And he didn't say anything to me. And then that Monday morning, Wobo called me with the answer. And I have not stopped praising Yah since, except for yesterday when I said to Obi, Lord, help me get up. And he said to me, Ima. And Isaiah said to me, your knees hurt because you ain't praying to the right person. But the good news is, young people, you are so much to Yah right now. Because as Elder Ibri said, we're the last. We're the ones who went through the 60s, the 70s, and the 80s, unfulfilled in so many ways. Bright as pennies, there is no more gifted race than this Hebrew family. No more gifted race than this Hebrew family. You've got to know it, you've got to say it, you've got to believe it, you've got to preach it. We're so special. Why? We're not black. We're none of those names. We are Hebrew Israelites. Oh my God. You don't know what that means to my generation of people. To have a defining, something that finally says who we are. Not looking and searching for a new name this month. Most of us hadn't gotten used to being called African Americans before. We were called African Americans and then Afro-Americans. You know, what's the difference? Is it the hairdo? please tell me the difference, because as far as I'm concerned, we're still in the same boat we were in the day before. No, this is it. This is it, young people. Please hold on to this. Don't let it go, because in here is Yah. In here is real family. This has nothing to do with blood. That's important, okay? That is important. But this has to do with the will, the teaching, the Torah. This has to do with the love we feel for each other when we really would like to hit each other with a brick. You know, we love each other anyway. It's hard. So I'm going to close, and I'm going to close. You know, I have to give a part of a song because I never remember all the words anymore. Because I have some timers. Sometimes I do. Sometimes I don't. But this song, I love, and the emails have heard it, and I know they're sick of hearing it, but I can't help it. It's just a little snippet, because I swear, I don't remember the words. Okay. You just keep on climbing until you reach your goals. Just keep on striving with all your heart and soul. All things are possible with Yah, so don't give in. He'll move your mountains, and He believes in your dreams. Shalom.
Beautiful, 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 fam. So what I'm going to do real quick is that I'm going to empty these CDs out of here, Ak, and you can take it over here and get started with the collection over here, Ak, until we get it filled up. Hey, I mean, we need a building. We outside. What y'all talking about? So yeah, go ahead and get started over here, Ak. But check this out. We got Iman John come up here with another poem. Then we got two singers. Y'all know these. All
right.
I'm not even going to. You'll see. You'll see. So Iman, come on up and bless us with your beautiful poems here as we get today's service going. And one more thing, those ox that took the food over to the cabin, go get it. You got 10 minutes. If you're not in 10 minutes, you're in trouble. So go get it. All right. Here you go.
Shabbat shalom, family.
Shabbat shalom.
I just want to say hallelujah for letting us come here. It's just wonderful to meet you all, to put a face with a name. And it's so much I want to say, but I just want to say hallelujah, because with all the stuff that I know now, I was in church all my life. And the time that I've come to HI, my eyes have been opened by Yah. And I just want to say hallelujah, and I leave it at that.
Hallelujah.
I sit and I think sometimes, you know, when people look at you, they always want to point their finger at your sin, but you can't see theirs. And I came up with this. What if sin had a color? What if sin had a color? What color would you be? Would you bear a streak of yellow from your cowardice ways, from all those times when you should have stood up and said something and did something when you did nothing? Or would you reek of red from your murderous hands, from that drive-by that you did back in the day that fell through the crack? Mm-mm, you didn't get away. Oh, if sin had a color. Some of us would glisten from orange from our fornicating ways, looking for love in all the wrong ways. Or would your tongue be black from all your backbiting ways and all those lies that you told that you inflicted upon the innocent ones? Or the lies that you told just for fun? Oh, if sin had a color. Or would you be blue from all the voodoo that you do in your secret hideaway places? Would you be purple? Would your hands be purple from all your thievery ways, from all the things that you stole that wasn't nailed down, and when you stuck your hand in your mama's purse? Ooh, if sin had a color. Some of us would be green with envy from my envious spirit that we possess. Anytime your neighbors or your friends got something and you wanted it too, what if sin had a color? If sin had a color, what color would I be? For I have not always walked on the path that Yah has set for me.
oh so lost back in the day, just trying to find my way. Oh, if sin had a color, what color would our young ones be? For they have been watching us, you see. Nah, this can't be. For our sins has a color. And if they did have a color, what color would you be? I'm sorry. Oh, if our sins had a color, what color would you be? Will we be rainbow-colored people as happy as can be? No, I don't think so, you see, because no one could point the finger, not you, not me, if sin had a color.
Hallelujah. 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 All right, hallelujah, excellent. One real quick frequently asked question that I'm going to ask, you know, to the IH crowd. Moshe has not cloned himself and called his clone Dale. They are not blood brothers. They are brothers by the blood. All right? Okay. That's Moshe in the red. That's Dale in the brown. Time for war. Yes, SM tonight. I've just been getting that question all week long. Is that Moshe? Is that Moshe? That's him right there. All right. So, fam, we got singers coming up now. See, if I'd have brought my tap shoes, I might have forgot to put my tap shoes in there. I would have danced for y'all, but I can't do that. So they're going to sing. So, hey, come on up, little coachy. She just came up to me. She was like, Obadiah, I want to sing. I had to, what? Obadiah, I want to sing. I was like, okay. Let's see what she got to say. Here you go. I know her moms can sing, and her father can rap, so she's in a talented family, so I know she's going to bless us, fam. Give her a warm welcome.
Hello, my name is Heaven, and I'd like to sing a song. I hope tomorrow will bring a better you, a better me. I know that we'll show this world we got more we could be. She should never give up on your hopes and your dreams. You gotta get up, get up, get into it, get it on to be strong. If we try, we can fly to a whole nother place. All we need is belief and a smile on our face. We can go anywhere we want, any road we decide to take. And we're never, never, never too far from tomorrow today. Everybody say tomorrow is just for us to share. And we're gonna send our message of love out everywhere. There's a promise of love. Tomorrow has something special in us, something we know will last and last. Cause we're never far away, never one thing I can always be sure of. Far away, no, never the promise of today.
Yeah!
Thank you.
All right, fam, that was beautiful, 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 beautiful. Yah has blessed us with much talent. Oh, he does? Okay, we're going to line him up right behind her. I see Sheeta's in line, so she's going to be after him. And then, okay, fam, we're going to keep the show rolling. We're going to get you brewed something to eat in just a moment, so don't throw your cameras up here at me and, you know, start a riot. That would be Yah-like, so we're not going to do that. So come on up, Okochi. Now, y'all have heard her sing before. This is Aki Rio's wife. Y'all, I mean, she...
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
I can't hear y'all. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Hallelujah. It is such a blessing to be here. And we are all so blessed right now. I don't think y'all even realize that. This is beautiful, right? I pray that next year we can see everybody again and maybe add some new faces to our family. Hallelujah. I'm going to come to you all today with a song. I know it's a big concert later on this evening, but I do my thing doing praise and worship, so that's what I'm going to do.
All right.
y'all pray for me as I come for you, come to you with this song. Blessed assurance, Yahushua is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. I'm an heir of salvation. I've been purchased by born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, yeah, yes. And I'm praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. Oh, and this is my song, yeah, 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 yes. And I'm praising my Savior. I'm praising my Savior. And I'm praising my Savior. Oh, the day long.
Hallelujah. Beautiful, beautiful. You know, the Malachim is singing and rejoicing to Yah, family, and just being out here today. And I looked up in the sky, I saw the sun just staying over, just bright, just shining down upon us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we got the little eye going to come up here. He said that this is a song that he and his moms has made up called I Am Hebrew, right? Come on up, eye. So give him a warm welcome, family, as he blesses us with another Yah fearing song. Hallelujah. Here you go. Yeah.
I am a Hebrew. I am a Hebrew. All right. I am a Hebrew. I follow Yah. He is my father. And I am a Hebrew. Yahushua, he is my savior, and I am a Hebrew, Hebrews.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praises be to his name, and his name is what?
Yah.
What?
Yah.
What?
Yah.
Hallelujah. All right, fam, I think that's all we have here. I think we cleaned the house of all the talent today. Everybody else want to just enjoy the beautiful shalom we had. Let me look over my shoulder to see if there's anybody else like beckoning, like, open the door. Wait. Okay, they all gone. We good. All right, fam. So, one more. Uh-oh. One more. Here we go. One more. Okay, hey, I could you... I know you're finna bust a rhyme, right? I'm just finna talk to you. I was about to get my beatboxing on for you, all right? No. It's all good.
We can run DMC, you know?
Shabbat Shalom. How everybody feeling? Good. I'm so blessed to be here. You know, wasn't looking like we was gonna be able to make it, but you know, praise Yah, He saw a way for us to make it. My brother Zeph, you know, he contributed to that. You know, and I'm thankful, very thankful for him. So I know we got a concert later. You know, but I'm just hit y'all with a little acapella something that I did before. You know, because as Hebrews, we see the world differently. You understand? Yah has opened our understanding to see through the lies, to see through the fog, you know. So this is a little something I'm just going to share for y'all. This is Dawid, child of Yah. Here we go right here. I'm a set apart, serving, observing, watching the lies. Yah gave me vision, I'm seeing through the disguise. Why they try to paint a picture that's perfect, pretty, and pink? Propaganda everywhere, influencing what you think. Might as well be a clone, living life as a drone. Satanic programming with no thoughts of your own. It's okay to be gay. Homosexuals cool? This the type of madness being taught in our schools. Trying to turn our young kids to university fools. This whole educated system is only a tool for their mind control. Protect your mind and soul. Long as I'm alive, I'ma show the lies exposed. Before it's too late, look, we dealing with straight crooks. But our people don't know. All they use is Facebook. Better get some real literature and open your scripts. Throw them falling ones come, you'll be fully equipped, or your mind might slip looking up at a ship. The whole iceberg's left. This is only a tip. With that being said, let's endure to the end. But what do I know? I'm just a Hebrew with a pen.
Yeah!
Woo! Hallelujah! Yah has put talent in the midst of our people. We always have had talent, family. So, bless. That I will be performing at the concert. So, hey, you're going to get more of that. What's up? Y'all finna sing? Yeah, you say sing and dance? Yeah, that other microphone is on. This one is actually on, too. So, we can have y'all. You can either go grab that one or we can just get you up here. It's y'all choice. Okay. Hey, now these brews get down. I know y'all have heard them too. And their email was with them. They sung a song one Shabbat that was just so beautiful. It was like, wow, I want you to sing that again and again. The same song? What's the name of it? Okay. You heard it? Let's give it to them. Give them a warm welcome, fam. Hallelujah.
Hey, Shabbat Shalom, fam. Just a quick testimony about this song. Yah gave it to me quite a while ago, and we were with another group of Hebrews. This is when we basically first came into the walk, and we had sang the song, and then after I had sang it, I sang it by myself the first time. After I had sang it, they asked me to sing it again so they could record it. So I was getting ready to sing it again, and it's like Yah completely wiped my mind. I could not remember a single word. So then somebody was like, hey, well, maybe he's not supposed to sing it. You know, or excuse me, maybe it's not supposed to be recorded. So after that, you know, they said, okay, we won't record it. Bam, words came right back. So it wasn't for them. It wasn't for those Hebrews. It was for us. It's for us here today. So the name of the song is Yah Knows Where You Are. And that's it. Normally I would play on the keyboard, but I'm gonna leave that alone today, so we're just gonna sing an acapella. Alright, me and Akoti Maria, my sister.
Shabbat Shalom.
In sync.
Yah knows where you are, Israel, and He knows how to gather you. You've never been too far, Israel. Trust in Yah will bring you through. And see while there is still breath in me. And I will trust in your wisdom. Cause you can and you will. You are Yah. The apple of your eye, you will redeem. The nations of the earth will see that you alone are Yah. No one else can save. Be praised for all eternity. And I will praise your name, Yah. While there is still breath in me, and I will trust in your wisdom, cause you can and you
You ready, Yah? One,
two, three.
Check this out real quick, family. I just want to say really a heartfelt thanks to you all. This is, like I say, you are here because Yah brought you here. This is not a social gathering. We're not trying to get numbers here, but Yah brought you here.
Hallelujah.
I've just been noticing just the feel all day long, fam, how it's been just so much shalom. And we want to build on that. That's what we want to do. And then what we're doing tomorrow, fam, we hope that we can just imprint that in stone. All these beautiful songs. Oh, I'm sorry. Hold on. Let me make sure. Okay. All right. Because I was recording everything. So we're going to be pressing all those songs you heard into the new Broke Man record album. It'll be out later on tonight. So get your $29.95 ready so you can get that new copy. All right. So we good. But go ahead, Ike. And,
I just want to say something real quick. And then,
real quick. I want to introduce somebody.
Okay. Listen. I just brought somebody in. He wasn't able to make it here at first. But he, you know, you guys was the reason because of this man with the music. All right. And I want him to say a few words. I want to introduce Yuri. Yo, Yuri, come on, greet the people. Give a hand for Yuri. Uriah. The real Hebrew.
The real Hebrew, yeah. I didn't mean to bust up the thought. Now, we got a great show for y'all tonight. Not only do we got Uriah, we got a hen. Hen. A hen. People want to hear from you. The Hebrews want to hear from Uriah and Hen. All right, y'all. Come on up here and talk to the people and let them know about your journey. Let them know y'all came for the lost sheep of Israel.
All right, Shabbat Shalom fam. Dang. All right. Shabbat Shalom family. It's definitely been a ride, you know what I mean, and it's been one heck of an experience, you know what I mean, and me and this man right here been through so much, you know what I mean, but it's all love, and you know we know y'all got some big things ahead of us right now, so we here, we made it, and we glad to see everybody out here. I can share my story real quick. I came from a past, you know, where I was lost a couple years ago. I was real lost. I was real, real lost. And I just really had to find myself. And, you know, obviously, you know, we're all here and we all know who we are now. You know what I'm saying? So we just gonna build off that and keep it moving. Now, there was once upon a time where I was, you know, I was doing the drug thing, you know, and just, you know, not caring about which route my life was heading, you know what I'm saying? And it was like one day this guy that I was selling crack to, you know, I was 21 years old, and this guy I was selling crack to, I mean, he was spending maybe like $300 with me every other day. And he came to my house, right? And the words he spoke to me was, he said, okay, look, I'm about to tell you something, but I want you to know that these words aren't coming from me. It's coming from some divine force that's working through me, and I feel like I have to tell you this. Now, he had the crack in his hand, and he said, he said, yeah, I know I'm buying this from you. I know I faithfully buy this from you, but this is not your calling. This is not your mission. You got something with you that's going to wake up multitudes of people. You're going to be a leader to so many people. So just prepare yourself for it. I didn't know what he was talking about at the time. I mean, you know, I was your regular ignorant, you know, had the gold in my mouth, jewelry, you know what I'm saying? I was acting like a straight nigga, you know what I'm saying? But when he said that, I didn't understand where he was coming from or where my life was headed. But literally like two, three weeks later, I started coming across this information, and it just made me realize what my mission was, you know what I'm saying? And like for a whole year, I just didn't do anything but just research and study and just, you know, found out more about who I really am. And then once it came to that point, it was like, okay, if I'm supposed to be a leader and really, you know, get this message out to multitudes of people, how am I gonna do this? And boom, it just hit me. I gotta start, you know, getting serious about this music thing. And so once I took it serious, you know, I mean, I was going through so much hate from I mean, I lost all my friends, though, my close circle. I lost everybody, you know, close to me. And I didn't know where my life was headed, you know what I'm saying? I just knew that, okay, I got this music, I got this gift that y'all's giving me. And, you know, I've always been a people person and to talk to people and really, you know, make people feel comfortable around me. But So once I started, you know, going with that again, just really getting involved with the music, there was just so much hate that I was about to give up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what? I'm not even about to do this. And I get a call from my father. He's like, yo, there's this producer, you know what I mean? He's with Israelite Heritage, and he does his thing, you know. He just came out with a mixtape, Hebrews Are. So, oh, he's about to come. It was like a couple weeks before you had already dropped it or something. And so I checked him out or whatever. I was like, and at first, you know, it was just
like I was whack.
That's I was like, man, we two total different opposite people, you know what I'm saying? It's just like, I wasn't really feeling him at first, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, and my wife is my witness. I just wasn't really feeling him at first, but it was like once he finally came to Virginia Beach, because he stays, Petersburg is an hour and a half from here, and he came to Virginia Beach and we met and we clicked and we just talked, and it was just like, yo, and we instantly just like, it was Yah ordained, you know what I'm saying? So everything worked out perfect, and the first thing we worked on was that All Around the World song, and since then it was just like, I mean, the chemistry was just so awesome that we came together and we did that weekend update, and we literally did that in like 2 weekends.
It was an accident. It really was.
Yeah, it really was just an experiment, just us putting something together, and we wanted to put together a project that can really attract everybody, you know what I'm saying? We wanted to really get to the kids, the adults, and at the same time, it was a relief to us, you know what I'm saying? It was a way we can, you know what I'm saying, just really put our thoughts into our art. And, you know, we went through some stuff behind that, you know. Some people thought it was too childish, you know, but it was something new, you know what I'm saying? This stuff is serious, you know. Being a Hebrew Israelite, knowing who we really are, is very serious, you know what I mean? But at the same time, we gotta put in a way to really just let people understand. We gotta attract everybody. Not everybody wants to hear the militant, serious side of it. So, you know, we try something. Then we just got so much good feedback that we continue to grow and, you know, work with each other and everything. And, like I said, it was a heavy experience. And you're right. I mean, do you want to tell your side of the story before I, you know, keep going? You know, because I could talk. I'll be here for like, you know, 5 hours talking your ear off. So, you know what I mean?
I could tell them a little something about myself. My background was a little different. Actually, me and Hen parallel each other in ways like most people would never know. Hen is actually younger than me. Believe it or not, he's a week younger than me. We both born in June. He's a week younger. I'm the older guy, the leader. No, I'm just kidding. And we both got two siblings younger than us, both 3 years apart, right?
Yep, exactly.
Yeah, and you know what I'm saying? Like, everything was just so much similar. And when we first met, it was really crazy. I actually came down to Virginia Beach to get immersed. That's the reason why I came down. I did not actually come down to meet this guy. Contrary to what he might think, you know what I'm saying? Nah.
I knew what it was, man.
But on a serious note, though, well, talking about the music, the reason why I did the first mixtape, I'm actually a producer. That's my main thing, is doing this music. I don't really like to get on the mic. I don't really like to hop on the track, even though it might look otherwise. But I put together my first mixtape because I couldn't find anyone else who was trying to do music similar to or get out this message the way that I wanted it to be put out. And so I put out my first mixtape, and then when I got to meet this guy right here, I was like, all right, whew, I finally got somebody who I can really, you know what I'm saying, put the music together for. I can sit behind the scenes and really work on what he was doing. And so that's what leads us up to today with the appetizer, the mixtape we just dropped a couple days ago. Mm-hmm. Me and my partner Brad Moss, I'm sure a few people heard of him. We go by the first kind now. That's our production duo. We are, our goal is to really be the next super producers from Virginia, and because that's what Virginia is known for. It's known for its production. It's known for its creativity. It's known for, you know what I'm saying? It's a serious music scene out here. And so we put together his mixtape. We worked really hard on it. Stayed up all night. I mean, and I have a full-time job. And so I would work from 9 to 5. I would come home at 6. I would go to bed at 4, wake back up at 9. I mean, I did this for like 3-4 weeks straight. And he might not know that though, but now he knows. So he know what time it is. But you know, this is really a full-time job. You can't do this as a hobby and expect your music to really get out there for those who are serious about doing this music. And you know what I'm saying? The goal is for me to one day, very soon, not have to work like that and to be able to work on this music full-time. But you have to really grind. You have to really get out there. You have to really network. You have to really go into the midst of these den of thieves, man. You can't be afraid of these people. You can't be afraid to get in there. You can't be afraid to say what, you know, say what you're into, how you feel, what's your goal, what's your motivations. You can't be afraid of those things, because you know, fears are one of our biggest problems, one of our biggest challenges. And so, you know what I'm saying, that's one of the things I like to talk about. I like to promote. I talk about that a lot with the people I'm around, because just like him, I had to change the people that I was around. I used to be in a fraternity. I was in Phi Beta Sigma. I was heavily into the college life. I was heavily into just all kinds of craziness. And then, you know what I'm saying, when I really came into this walk, I came into this truth, I completely surrounded myself with people who were like-minded. Everybody that I'm around is not necessarily, oh, I'm gung-ho Hebrew, but I learned to like just sit back in the cut and chill and just show them what I was doing. And now, like at my crib and what we do, nobody eats unclean foods. Everybody keeps their Shabbats. Everybody, you know what I'm saying, is in one accord and not even realizing it, you know what I'm saying? And so that's one of the things I had to do was you are who you hang around. That's the truth. You are who you hang around. You are who you know what I'm saying? Like just take a look at the people you're around every day and it's like, okay, you know what I'm saying? And so you know, that's what brings that brings us back up to here today, because you know, I wasn't even gonna make it. I actually had a gig with Brad Lawson, the New Age, today. It was gonna be a paid gig. They was gonna pay us very well, and it got canceled at the last minute. And I called up him, and I was like, "Oh man, I get to see the Bruise. It's about to be a party now." But yeah, all right, so I did what I could, because my car couldn't make it, but one of my best friends, this guy named Chris, and another good friend of mine, Will, they went to Hampton University. And they was like, well, we'll go chill in Hampton, and we can bring you up there, you know what I'm saying, and make it happen. And so they was like, yeah. So, you know what I'm saying, I gave them a few dollars so they can get up here, you know, with the gas and whatnot, and I made it up here. And the only thing I can say about that is hallelujah. That's the only thing I can say. It's enough said. It's nothing else to say. And so, yeah, I'm just excited to be here. I'm excited to get to see all of y'all. I'm excited for y'all to get to see me, because I'm just a normal dude. Don't big me up. Don't come over here talking about something. Oh, man, your music the best. Like, how y'all be doing? It's okay. No, it's hot. Y'all can go and say it's hot. But, yeah, I just want to say Shabbat Shalom to everybody before the sun finished going down. And it's good to see you guys. You ready? Okay.
All right. But yeah, definitely. So we just, you know, happy to see everybody here, you know, and much love to all the artists that's out here, that, you know, everybody in Israelite Heritage doing their thing. And I mean, there's some great music coming out, you know what I mean? And it takes time, growth, and dedication, you know, a lot of learning experiences. And, you know, what I understood is, you know, going through those trials and tribulations. And, I told some people here that I would share a little bit of my testimony of when I had to do my jail time a couple weeks ago. But some people, you know, it looks like a rough situation, you know, to, you know, him going to jail and, you know, but when it first happened, I thought, you know, that the devil was really trying to do something, you know.
One that called the cops.
Anyway, but yeah, I thought the devil was trying to, you know, really do something, you know, just trying to, you know, take my shine, just trying to stop and make me move back, you know, backwards from what I had going on and stuff. And what was funny is, you know, what I went to jail for, I had a warrant from back in 2007. You know, back, you know, with my drug related charges, but all the, you know, I'm sorry. Oh, okay. Yeah. But, I had, you know, a couple years I was just, you know, going around on a warrant and didn't even know about it until in early August I get pulled over, and then I find out I have a warrant. And then, you know, I go to court not even thinking that, you know, I'm thinking I get a fine or something. But, you know, the judge gave me 10 days. Now, it was like right when that happened, that's when I understood. It was like, yo, this thing is about to get real, because, you know, at this point in time, I don't even belong in jail. I'm not even built for that. That's nowhere I belong right now. You know, I got a wife and I'm going on my fourth child. Like, I need, you know, I got a family and stuff. But what happened, once I got there, it was just like the set apart spirit was really, really moving. And I mean, every day from I mean, people 18 to 42 years old, I mean, in tears with the information I was giving them about who they are, you know, and, you know, not to look down on their situation. And I mean, I know people ready to eat, so I'm going to go ahead and just cut it short. Just no matter what the situation looks like, you know, we all got our separate missions and stuff, and we just have to understand that, you know, let everybody walk the individual path, you know. And there's been a lot of, you know, misunderstandings, miscommunications, people not really understanding what my individual mission is, what Uriah's individual mission is. And we hear the fellowship and talk, you know what I'm saying? So that's what being a brew is about, you know. We got to let our love and our light shine. So we're definitely glad to be here. We're trying to have some fun. We know everybody ready to eat, so we're going to have to cut it short right now. Shabbat shalom, everybody.
Shabbat shalom.
All right, all right.
Trust in me.
All right, y'all, give it up. Give it up, y'all. Hallelujah.
That was beautiful. Definitely beautiful.
Yes. Because, you know, I was just back here talking to an Ak and a Koti. And what Amaz and them were doing, can you all imagine when we're in the kingdom? Can you imagine when we're in the kingdom hearing stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about. Who's next here?
Next we got Aki Rio getting ready to do his thing. We trying to
set right.
Real quick.
Yeah.
Come on out. Uh-oh, I coming with the kazale.
Oh, he doing that. Yeah.
See, that's what I like.
Yeah.
Back in the day when you got Shell Toe Adidas, Kangos, and Kazelles, it's like that, y'all.
Yeah.
That, y'all. All
right, check this out. Israelites, I need some participation.
Hold on,
I need some participation. Check this out. When I ask y'all, are y'all ready to rock? I need y'all to say, we ready to rock, all right? Israelites, are y'all ready to rock? Say, one more time. Israelites, are y'all ready to rock? Say,
you ready? Okay.
No doubt. And bands gather round, y'all. We about to get it in.
Get it in.
Up first, it's y'all Op Rio. With that rough around the edge, not that smooth or regal. Your host of what coming back, and we prepping for that. Sharpening the heart and mind, getting ready for combat. Rhetoric coming from a pastor, a rabbi, a reverend. We liking that type of talk to quicksand. Taking you where you don't want to be. Hallelujah for allowing us to see this truth. And to record in a booth, we are troops in a set apart squadron. Aiming for victory, gonna get it by a slight margin. I'm inspired by y'all's walk. Stand strong, cause the adversary stalk. He's trying to find a way to get in. Crack your window, he in your den or your living room. Kick him out, keep him out. We about to blow when it's prophesied, so you already know. Steady flow, truth to show. Here we grow into the credits roll. Elders and coaches and odds, gather round, y'all. Israelites about to rock. Rock, 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 rock. Odds and coaches, bots, elders and bands, gather round, y'all. We about to get it in. Get it in. Get them heaven. Smoothly, Bins and bots, elders and coaches and odds, gather round, y'all. Israelites about to rock, 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 rock. Odds and coaches, bots, elders and bins, gather round, y'all. We about to get it in, get it in, get it in. Check this out. Abundance, a blessing of those that know this truth.
The armor of y'all is more than bulletproof.
A guillotine won't do a thing, that's on a physical only. Abbas, Emas, and elders, once were failures, now believers and achievers.
Shalom to all, everyone listening, keep the Father's commandments, and you're saying keep listening.
Live from District 4, we wish to do the Father's will and nothing more. Shalom. Right there. One, two, right there. Hallelujah.
Come on.
Hallelujah.
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 time for them.
That's
what I'm talking about.
That's Steve.
All right. Now that's my man. You know what I'm saying? I bring the next generation up the right way. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah. All right, y'all. I got Yakanan on the phone right now. He's about an hour away. Everybody's looking forward to seeing you.
Yeah.
Let me see if you can say something. Hold on. Let me see. Speak through the mic.
We can hear.
Shalom.
Hold on. I'm gonna turn it up. Hold on. You ready? Hold on. Hold on. Let me turn the mics down. Wait. Speakerphone.
Hey, how you put the song back? He old
school. Yeah, that's right.
Trying to get him on that technology.
Difficult.
That ain't my phone, that's all. Oh, okay. I had my phone.
Yeah.
Excuses.
Go ahead, Ock. That's all right. That's all right. That's what I'm saying.
All right.
Give it up for Yah.
That's what it is.
That's my DJ. All right, now. Who's next?
Next on.
Let's keep this going. We got to keep it moving.
Next on the mic, we got Aaliyah.
Oh,
yeah. Aaliyah, she going to come.
Is that Louisiana? Is that Louisiana?
And get it.
Louisiana style. All right, now. That's Louisiana in the house. Aaliyah, give it up, y'all. Yeah. You ready to get it? You ready to get it?
I'm ready.
Let's go. Put your hands together.
Can't nothing take your place. Driving every day. Every day.
Spit that.
With my head to the sky. Uh-huh. Ain't nothing else to do but to serve ya.
Yeah.
Don't like me because I love ya. Yes, I love ya. And yes, I trust in ya. He lives in me. And he is all I need to end. Do it to the end. His love will never end. They won't mean to sin, but it's not like that. Do in my life, but I'm living for y'all. Ain't nobody gonna stop me now, hold me down. Cause I'm a servant of y'all, I'm walking in faith. Can't nothing take y'all place. I'm striving every day, every day. I'm striving every day, walking in faith. Satan trying to take y'all place. He trying to steal my grace. Ruin everything in my face. He try to get me at my weakest, but it's okay. I keep on striving, keep on striving. When y'all walking by my side, that's all it takes. I got my mind made up, cause that's no other way. I gotta hold on to faith, keep pushing for a better day. Y'all, Hoshua is coming, like it or not. See, I'ma tell it like it is, that's without a doubt. I got and every day, every day, every day.
Next we got Aki Dale.
Aki Dale.
Come on.
Soon to come again, redeeming us to the Father. Put your armor on you, I'm preparing for the slaughter. Tell it to you.
What's wrong? Hey, my fault. Hey, my fault. My fault. My, hey. That's my fault. Number three, my fault. Let's go.
No!
adjust his mic.
Take your time, Ock. Take your time. Get in.
Get in the
zero, Ock, in you. Because everybody, we was waiting to see you, Ock. Yes. Are y'all ready? I said, are y'all ready? All right, stand up and throw your hands in the air if you're ready. You ready, Dawee? Bring them home. IH, set up
our music.
IH, set up our music.
You ready to get this thing started out?
I'm ready.
I'm waiting for your cue.
I'm ready to take them on a journey, but I gotta hear that one more time, because the music we make ain't like the world music. You understand? This music right here gonna change the world.
Hallelujah.
You understand? This music right here has the spirit of Yah in it. So I want y'all to participate with me, and let's say that one more time, because the Malakim is listening right now. Set apart music. I need y'all to be with me. I need y'all to listen. I spit the truth. Everything's been verified. I rap clean. Uh-oh. My pen's been sterilized. Israel's waking up. Now they terrified. If you ain't about y'all's business, step aside. Yeah. Let the real men get recognized. Every day I breath the life is jeopardized. My people lack knowledge, so they run a game on them. Look in their faces. I see the pain on them. So I carry their burdens on each shoulder. Selling blowout women on the stripper boat. Push your morals, hit the floor, do anything to pay the bill. 400 years still ain't on a level playing field. Systematic breakdown, built for you especially.
Yeah.
Put you in the game, then they turn and play the
get
referee.
Come on,
so you never ever level that you thought you should. Find out the government,
yeah.
Cheating more than Tiger Woods. Corporation bailout, predatory lending, the institutional collapse, economics, still blame destroy.
Yeah.
Real foreign policy, it's all big. Why they leaving you in poverty? Totally dependent prophecy. It was written you a second class citizen. 14th Amendment, and you won't be this condition by signing a petition or million man march with Yah's where it starts.
I don't think that
the whole world worship the sun and moon. It's okay, our redemption is coming soon. This a marathon. I need some running room. Not a sprint. Sometimes it don't make sense to work so hard. Can't make rent. Frustration. I feel fed up, but I think about my father, keep my head up. And praise Yah, we can sing now. And you an Israelite, you should feel free now. You should praise Yah, you should feel free now. If your family thinks you sing now, it's okay, because we should feel free now.
Let me know.
some noise.
Let me hear it one more time. Praise God. We can see now. And how y'all feel? Charts. I don't make these songs to try to get paid. I don't make these songs for fam. I make these songs for the people of Yah. I make these songs for the people of Yah. And I put it out, and where it falls is where it falls. You understand? We gotta let them know that. The kind of love the world have. That baby, you look so good. I wanna take you home, love.
Yuck.
That ain't the kind of love that we about.
Yes.
Kind of love that them 20-inch rims look nice, brother. You know,
right.
I want some of that money. That ain't the kind of love we about.
That's what?
The kind of love we about.
It's nothing.
That love that you have for your Isha. That love that you have for your brother. Okay. That love that Dawid and Yathanun had. That's the kind of love we talking about.
Let's
that Yah is love.
Come on.
Y'all cry with me. Yah is love.
That's right.
I need crowd participation on this one.
Don't forget the length of the wire, though.
Yes, sir.
All right?
Yes, sir.
Love, truth, that's just a few of his attributes. When his word goes out, it's absolute. No need to amend it. Who can rescind it? Does exactly what it's intended. And when it comes back, it's done so splendid. And he's on your side, you can feel on the tyrant. Cause with what's gone, he's a slayer, giant, standing in the fire. And I get a scratch in a den full of lions. And I get attacked. Don't worry about the rear, y'all got your back. Tell me who else got power like that. And that alone
is
such a blessing to receive your grace. Feel so good just to seek your face. The Almighty and He dwells up above.
Yah is love.
Such a blessing to receive your grace. Feel so good just to seek your face. The Almighty and He dwells up above.
Yah is love. Come on.
Yah is His name, not God. That's a fucking title. That's a pride to an idol. Knowing this so vital. Yah has no equal. It's for all people. When it come in, it don't take nothing drastic. Hold to the covenant and you can be grand.
I hear you,
with the nation on one accord, living as a righteous civilization.
Come on.
Love is an action, not just a word. Keep that in mind when he shows you compassion.
Yeah.
Mercy and kindness is from everlasting. He knows what you need before you even ask
him. Yeah.
Have belief and the rest he'll supply you. Take the kingdom, no way he'll deny you.
Come on.
Don't worry, he can hear your prayers. You can call on God, cause he's always there. Such a blessing to receive your praise. Feel so good just to seek your face. The Almighty and He dwells up above.
God is love.
Such a blessing to receive your grace. Feel so good just to seek your face. The Almighty and He dwells up above.
God is love.
Yeah.
Yeah. Y'all put your hands together. It's right there. Yeah. Yeah, it's real.
Let's give it up for Tyree one more time.
Music we make again.
Set apart music.
Okay, now we don't know what the Western world do, but when we go out and pass them flyers, this is what we tell them. We serving y'all over here.
Hey, what are you doing?
We serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
Serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
Serving y'all over here. H, set apart music. I need everybody to get up on this one, even the E-Mocks. Let's go. We serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
We set apart in our way so they ain't used to it. Get your living right. Yeah, I got real. Get your living real. Why you got time? We serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
We set apart in our way so they ain't used to it. Get your living right. Yeah, I got mine. About y'all's business when I come around. Yeah, see my light shine even when the sun is down. This a different type of life, you should try it out. Only time I'm on the block is if I'm passing flyers out. I ain't in the game, so I ain't repping no flags. Yeah, I'm a grown man, so my pants ain't sagging. It's about y'all, you hear me bragging. Not about you, the playing 20s on the wagon. Sounding like fools, perpetuating this ignorance. Get up off the mic, you ain't saying nothing significant. They acting like civilized and doing silly dance. Yeah. Coons of the year, come on. Time for an improvement. Servant of the king, and the way is the movement. Close shop, we ain't buying what you're selling. And when we come around, this is exactly what we tell them.
Yeah.
Southern flow, bring it to the birds and let the brothers in the gutter know. Truth don't cost you a dime, y'all got it for the low. Your philosophy, don't try to go there. Trust me, serving the devil's gonna get you nowhere. But you think you're phony cause you got a record label, but you only get scraps up here moving out of the table. Y'all rap come, you think that money go? Then it's too late, you realize that they played you. Better get it right, any day could be your last. Put sand back in the hourglass. Like killing, not my father's word is established. Uh-huh. Turn off the radio, this music's so average. Be real, you can't compare me to these rap dudes.
Yeah.
We ain't in the same. Astronomy. You wanna know what's going on? Read through the rhyme of here. We ain't been dispersed, huh? Probably got a curse. Go and look at Haiti, y'all checking out the earth. Yeah, worry about America, she gonna get it worse. Your pain medication, cause they say the truth hurts. At my concert, dealing with some converse. If they wanna learn more, later we can converse. I'm a man of God, and I'm handling my dues.
Let's go.
Life, no, she ain't gotta worry about it. Showing your allegiance with the alphabet signs. Set apart music. You know what we worship while the blind lead the blind. We serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
We set apart in our ways so
they ain't used to it.
Get your living right.
Yeah, I got mine.
Get your living right.
Why you got time?
We serving y'all over here.
What are you doing?
And they ain't used to it. Get your living right.
Yeah, I got mine.
Get your living right.
Why you you got time. All right, these mics are hot.
All right, we gotta get some.
All right, y'all, take a seat. Now we get ready to get to the main attraction. But I think, you know what? The set apart music artist, Broke Man Records, a set apart production. This is all done by a set apart production. Set apart music production. So we getting ready to showcase him. Uriah. And I got a young girl by the name of Kay Scott. Kay Scott is gonna give y'all a treat. She's a special treat, y'all. You ready, man? You wanna do something?
Hello.
You wanna say something else?
Alright.
Alright, y'all ready? Let's keep this show going, because we're pressing for time. Y'all ready for some good sound? Y'all ready for some good music? I don't think so. Y'all ready for some good music? Uh-oh. I think y'all tired. Y'all ready for the eat? Y'all ready to eat again? All right, y'all. Come on, come on. All right, all right. I don't know. I think the IH artists, I hope they didn't make y'all nervous. Wow. I feel like that weed in them. Ready to war, ready to fight. There you go. Man. Yeah. Oh, she didn't get scared. She just, you know. It's overwhelming. This is all overwhelming, y'all. You know? I say, man, me and Imao came a long way. A long, long way. You know? When I met this woman, I don't think she liked me. I ain't really care for it neither, you know? But I, you know, from the neck down, I did like what I saw, you know? So, I ain't saying she was ugly, but you know, we'll be real. And you know, no, you were thick. And I like thick women, you know, as you can see.
Whoa, hey.
I love you, my y'all. I really do. You know, I've been with her 24 years. Clap your hands for that. 24 years with that woman right there. With that same lady. It's still all right, y'all. I'm telling you.
I'm not trying to hear that.
What?
Yo. Talking about her body.
That's how you was made, sucker.
Hey. Hey, round of applause to that.
Yes, yes, y'all. Come on now.
So
you ready?
We trying to get it. We're going to knock it out real quick. Is y'all ready?
Hey, can we get the drummer man to do some drums and get y'all amped up?
Hey,
come on, James. Give us some drums or something.
Little drummer boy. You know what I'm saying? Y'all give a hand to them. You know, they came
from
Petersburg, Virginia.
Petersburg, y'all.
Which is an hour and a half away. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They show love. And
they're near Richmond.
Trying to learn more about this Hebrew walk. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
He came up to me just like literally like 10 minutes ago. Was like, you know, I really love what's going on out here, and you know, I really want to learn how to bring this truth to my father. You know what I'm saying? And I was trying to tell him, I was like, look, it's gonna be us to bring this truth to our parents and our grandparents and stuff like that. So
yes.
You know what I mean? Just y'all keep you know, keep the people encouraged that's trying to live and learn this truth, because, you know what I'm saying, we all came from it, you know what I'm saying? We all were lost at one time. So we can't look down on anybody who's like fighting to learn this truth. We got to show our love and let our light shine on it. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all could put y'all hands together for my drummer, you know what I'm
yes,
saying?
Yes, yes.
Show him love, man.
Yeah.
All right.
K Scott, yeah. you wanna open up or
yeah,
you
I want. Wait? Yeah, I want.
Okay.
This is
a special treat, y'all. Special. I want y'all to know, K Scott, remember this. This is a special treat. This is what I talked about a lot. You know, we love this lady. Yes. Hallelujah. Say, hey, give it up for K Scott, y'all. Come on, y'all. Yeah. Give it up to her. Y'all brought her a long way, too.
Yes, yes. She means a lot to our family, you know what I'm saying? And y'all is about to do some big things with her and I.
Ain't no cussing in this. Him wanted to hear the word, so I'm gonna sing the word. Haven't played in a while, so that was my rehearsal. I'm so thankful to have my life. But it hurts to listen. My heart is truly missing. Darkness seems to fall on me. That I am chosen, so I always see the light. I always see the light, yeah. Even when the switch is flipped on me, I will remain the same. Though others up and change, they go and curse my name and always place the blame while I try to stay sane. In this crazy world, this world I'm living in, this world is coming to an end. No need to be afraid, don't even worry. No one helped me find my place, all I really had was faith. Said I've been through so much, y'all. Me didn't know. No one helped me find my place. All I really had was faith. In this crazy world, this world I'm living in, this world is coming to an end. No need to be afraid. Don't even worry. No one helped me find my place. All I really have was faith in this crazy world, yeah. In this crazy world, yeah, yeah, yeah. In this crazy world, in this world, yeah.
Y'all make some noise.
Right.
My name is Hen. Shalom to everybody. We're going to get it started, and we're going to end this with a special song to me. And I'm pretty sure it's a special song to a lot of people. It's a war.
That's right.
mama. Yo, she called me Spring Lion, repping the city Zion. Lost soul still crying, and every day I'm reminded how this world is two-sided. One is dark as hell, the other's well-lighted. And any mountain I'll climb it, Mount Rushmore in the worst climate, cause I ain't scared.